Brian Baldinger, who wins the capper to week one in Oakland?
I think the San Diego Chargers are going to be the team to beat tonight and the team to beat in the AFC West this year. I'm taking the Lightning Bolts.
Paul Burmeister.
I think the only way you could pick the Raiders is if you thought Philip Rivers was going to implode, and I don't see that happening. I think he'll play very well, so I like the Chargers not just by a little, but by a whole lot.
Marshall?
I'm going to go with the Raiders.
There's in a game like this. The Chargers have won the last five meetings against the Raiders, and LaDainian Tomlinson 140 yards plus in those meetings.
Jamie Dukes.
Problem with the Raiders, they got the guy. I think he ran the Waffle House for about 7 years before he came back into the league, the offensive coordinator, so I'm going to stay with San Diego.
Wow. Okay. Brian.
A sold-out McAfee Coliseum in Oakland, California. Tonight, as we wrap up the NFL kickoff weekend, two of the NFL's brightest stars, LaDainian Tomlinson of the Chargers and Randy Moss of the Oakland Raiders. And they are all set and looking to shine in the bright lights of ESPN's Monday Night Football. Hi, everybody, and welcome to Oakland. I'm Brad Nessler. These two teams get together for the 94th time, and they're both looking for better things than a year ago. The Chargers, after winning the AFC West with 12 wins two seasons back, fell to 9-7, didn't make the postseason. For the Raiders, they obviously didn't make the postseason last year, as they were 4-12, and since Super Bowl 37, they have only 13 total wins. No playoffs, out goes another coach in Norv Turner. As we bring in my partners, Ron Jaworski and Dick Vermeil. And, Coach, you know these two coaches, both these guys, as well as anybody. Art Schell, second tour of duty with the Raiders. What's he bring to him?
Well, I think of talking with Art. He's going back to all the principles and philosophies that helped him be an eight-time All-Pro quarterback, offensive tackle, excuse me, and then end up playing on two Super Bowl teams and then turn around and coach three playoff teams as the head coach, topped off by being elected to the Hall of Fame. He brings great credibility. He's talking toughness, play the game smart, working hard, pads on, and they're bitching a little.
Well, we'll see if they take that discipline and if they bitch tonight a little bit. Philip Rivers makes his first start at quarterback for the Chargers in his third year. You remember your first start, Jaws?
I remember it precisely. It was my third year as well, and I only threw the ball 13 times in that game. I believe you will see Marty Schottenheimer manage Philip Rivers the same way. He will rely on number 21, LaDainian Tomlinson, in the backfield. LaDainian will have to wear the hat in this matchup. And again, at this McAfee Coliseum, LaDainian has averaged 142 yards per game in five visits. He will come up big in this one. I believe you'll see maybe 40 touches from LT tonight.
He says that he loves playing the Raiders as much as Marty Schottenheimer likes coaching against the Raiders. Going to be an interesting ball game tonight because the Chargers have won five straight over Oakland, and the Raiders are looking to snap that. Let's go down to the fourth member of our team, Bonnie Bernstein.
Well, Brad, Philip Rivers has been fascinated with football since he was about 4 years old. He is the son of a high school coach in Alabama. He told me he would sit in on meetings, learn the lingo, listen to how quarterbacks would break the huddle. Now the kid who grew up watching Monday Night Football will launch his career on this very same stage. And whether Philip wins or not tonight, he actually already has a small victory. He said, up until now, my four-year-old daughter, Hallie, always asked, Daddy, how come you never wear a helmet on TV? Well, Hallie, Daddy's definitely wearing one tonight.
And he'll have that chin strap wrapped pretty tight, I would think, against the Oakland Raider defense tonight. Randy Moss has been voted one of the captains for this Oakland Raider team. That in itself is an interesting situation. LaDainian Tomlinson, five straight years of over 1,200 yards rushing. Only Eric Dickerson to start his career has ever been that productive. Oakland won the toss, they will receive. That means Nate Kidding is set to kick off. This crowd is lit up. Some of them have been here since Friday afternoon. We're underway as we wrap up our doubleheader on Monday Night Football. Rashard Lee from about the four. And Lee gets it out across the 20 and out to about the 22-yard line. So a brand new quarterback for the Oakland Raiders. If Drew Brees wasn't in New Orleans, this guy wouldn't be here, and Philip Rivers wouldn't be starting for the other team. Aaron Brooks comes over after 5 years of starting in New Orleans.
You know, Aaron Brooks has the big arm. That fits nicely for Randy Moss's deep style of passing game. But as I've studied Aaron Brooks through his career, he must become more consistent. Only a 56% completion percentage. In a West Coast offense, he should be around 63 to 65%.
Randy Moss and Alvis Whitted go out to the top of your screen on first down for the Raiders from the 22-yard line. And now it's Moss in motion. And Brooks comes up throwing. Plenty of time, steps up, fires, complete, and it's going to be very close to a first down. Courtney Anderson, the tight end, made the stop. Let's check out the Raiders' offense, and Lamont Jordan will set it for us. Lamont?
The Raiders. Up front, anchored by my boy, the Undertaker, Robert Gallery. Skill positions, anchored by yours truly, Lamont Jordan, number one Lady Terps fan, national champs. And, of course, my boy, nappy head, Randy Moss.
Jordan had over 1,000 yards on the ground at 70 catches a year ago. He's the tailback in the eye. And a second down and one for the Raiders on their opening drive. And it is Jordan, left side, first down, Oakland out to the 34-yard line. Let's check the Chargers defensively, and Sean Merriman will do the honors.
Now introducing the 11 that you love to hate, up front anchoring the team, Jamal, defensive quarterback Williams. Behind him, you have Randall, the Rev, Godfrey, and a newcomer, Marlon, the president, McCree.
Good job, Sean. First down, and of course, the front seven of San Diego considered one of the best in all of football. And it's a different seven than it used to be. We'll develop that as we go. First down for the Raiders, their own 35. And it's Jordan again off that left side, and he got out to about the 39-yard line as he followed Robert Gallery. Gallery, the number one draft choice a year ago out of Iowa, and was the right tackle and has switched to the left side. In fact, much of that offensive front, different guys in different positions, Dick, and that's not always as easy as everybody thinks it is.
Now, fundamentally, it's a different kick step altogether, and plus his tattoo's on the wrong side.
He was an Outland Trophy winner for Kirk Ferentz at Iowa, and now playing his natural left side. We'll see if he protects it and blocks as well as he has on the first two runs. Pick up a three on the last one, second down and seven. Pressure off the corner, and Jordan, nice adjustment up the middle, got to about the 40-yard line, and that's where Randall Godfrey brought him down. The Chargers defensively last year were number one against the rush in the National Football League, and so far, Jordan's done a pretty good job on the ground. There you see, 28th against the pass. And Quentin Jammer said to us, you know, we get a bad rap about being 28th against the pass. When you're number one against the rush, somebody's going to put something in the air.
And they're playing catch-up football, and they're throwing the ball downfield on it. Exactly. So more pass attempts, more yards.
Three wide receivers now for Brooks as Ronald Curry joins the group. They're all bunched to the left side on a third down and four. Brooks looking that way. In trouble. He's got good wheels, and he's got a first down. All the way out to midfield and more. Aaron Brooks, and there's the dimension Kerry Collins didn't have a year ago.
This is one dimension that he can really bring to a football team. He's in pressure. If he doesn't see Ron what's downfield, he'll find a spot to go ahead and get upfield and get that first down.
Well, Coach, you're absolutely right. Mobility is about moving around in the pocket, not necessarily running for first downs, but in that particular situation, everyone was covered downfield. Aaron Brooks did an excellent job of tucking the ball away and picking up the first down, not making a huge mistake by trying to force the football.
Into San Diego territory. Raiders looking good on their opening march at the 49 of San Diego. And now Brooks, something he didn't like the look of, and he'll call a timeout. So we'll take it with him. Just underway in Oakland. 11-16 remaining first quarter. No score. We'll see if the Raiders can change that when we come back. In San Diego territory at the 49-yard line. The Raiders not only with a new head coach, but they go back to the future with their offensive coordinator, Tom Walsh, who was with Art Shell the last go-around. He's had out of football for a long time, Josh.
You know, and it's really difficult to catch up with the game. This game does not change every year. It changes every week. So he's had a lot of studying to do.
Brooks out first down. Going deep down the middle and in and out of the hands of Courtney Anderson, who should have had it, his tight end at the 25-yard line.
They brought both strong side linebackers, the inside guy and the Sam linebacker. Merriman on the outside created some pressure, turned the tight end loose inside, but it was a great hit, knocked the ball out.
But an excellent throw by Aaron Brooks. He hung nicely in the pocket to hit that seam. Anderson has to come up with that catch. Ooh. The ball was actually out before the hit by McCree, and boy, he could give him a shot.
Here's what they've got to do better than they did last year. They had 30 drop passes. That's 30th ranked in the National Football League. You cannot keep drives going if the receivers, which you get paid to do, catch a football and they drop it.
Randall Williams now will take Anderson's spot. He was shaken up on that bone-jarring hit to the helmet. It'll bring up second down and 10.
And Marlon McCree actually launched at Anderson. I'm surprised you didn't get a flag.
They come with the same linebacker, dog.
Jordan on a counter, and he's dropped in his tracks, a loss of one. And it's Terrence Keel from the safety spot. Made a great play there, and it's going to bring up the third down and long.
They expect Keel to really start maturing. He's been there a couple years. He's the second-round draft choice, Ronnie, and he had all the tools coming out of Texas. Now he's mature enough, I think, to start reaching his potential.
What was beautiful about that play was the diagnosis. A lot of guys see it, and they wait. Keel that time saw the play, read the play, attacked it, and made the play in the backfield before Jordan was able to get started.
First time the Raiders have been on a third and long on this opening drive. Third down and 11, the eighth play of their opening march. They're back in their own territory now. Brooks pressured, deep middle, and almost intercepted. Nearly picked off by Marlon McCree. So the Raiders had something going, and now they're going to have to give it up.
That's another reason the Chargers didn't intercept many passes last year, is they dropped too many. And here's an example right there.
They only had 10 a year ago. If you think that's bad, the Raiders only had 5 interceptions as a team, and he should have had that one.
You see Merriman get chopped down there?
Ooh, boy, that's what you got to do. Merriman's a big, strong guy. You go for that cut block, he's not going to get to the quarterback. You know what? That's going to slow him down a little bit on his next rush.
Shane Leckler will punt. And Eric Parker is back deep. Darren Sproles broke his leg in the preseason in the first game. He was their return man for the Chargers. Takes a big chunk out of their special teams. Parker is going to let it go. That's going to make the end zone. And the Chargers will come out to work at the 20-yard line. 50-yard punts. Phillip Rivers. Got to be some butterflies in there someplace. He'll take his first snap as a starter when we come back.
He's got nothing but
open. Let's see how much noise they make. Down in that end of the field for Phillip Rivers, whose offense is going to set up at the 20-yard line. As Bonnie said, he's been prepared his whole life. He said, the wait seemed like forever, but I learned a lot from Drew Brees. Now it's his time. First snap, first start from the 20 for the Chargers. Tomlinson cuts out, got about 4 behind his fullback, Lorenzo Neal, who's going to set the Charger offense for us right here.
Introducing the greatest offense on earth. At center, Nick Hardwick, the real deal, in your face, Hardwick. Now, let's talk about the skill positions. Let's talk about 21, Superman without the cape, LaDainian Tomlinson. At wide receiver, Keenan McCardell, steady as a rock, the ageless wonder.
The ageless wonder, the oldest wide receiver in the National Football League. End around coming, Eric Parker has got the first down and then some. All the way out across the 40. And out to the 42-yard line.
They brought the outside linebacker right into the reverse, but he didn't get it. They got around him anyway.
Asamoah made the stop defensively. Let's take another look.
You see 53 coming in there. Thomas Howard, they get around him anyway.
Well, Thomas Howard is a rookie, and a lot of times you will see coaches early in the ballgame try to take advantage of that aggressiveness. The guy's all lathered up. I mean, this whole stadium's lathered up. He over-pursued the play. They ran the reverse very effectively to his side.
Eric Parker, a pickup of 18 on the end around. And the Chargers have much better field position now at the 9:20 mark. Just outside their own 42-yard line. Antonio Gates in motion there. LaDainian Tomlinson, left side out to the 44, got about 2 yards. Warren Sapp, the big guy, number 99, set the defense, Warren.
Starting up front for the D-line, the NFL sack leader, Mr. Derek Texas Lee Burgess. The linebackers, hey, fast Thomas Howard, young 5'3", and on the back end in the secondary, we got Nnamdi. I cannot pronounce your name. Asamoah, awesome something. Yeah.
Try Asamoah, Warren. That's close enough.
Oh, boy. We've worked on that all week.
We have. Second down and 7. Rivers, first throw, swing, and got it to LaDainian Tomlinson perfectly on the fly, and first down, San Diego. Be honest with you, that's a tough throw, Jaws, and I thought he overthrew him.
Brad, I got to tell you, that is tremendous composure. He's got to throw it over the top of an on-rushing defender. You'll say it here. He gets nice touch over Derek Burgess. It looked like it was overthrown, but boy, that's great composure. A lot of times, young quarterback can just squeeze that a little bit and almost stick it right in Burgess' belly.
You got to think that the butterflies just calmed down their wings a little bit. Right.
Well, they brought people inside, so they lost the inside-out pursuit. But a safety playing a nickel, a linebacker came up inside.
Manu Maliuna is in there as a second tight end. Lorenzo Neal, the fullback in motion. On a first down, the counter, and Tomlinson again to about the 41-yard line. LaDainian Tomlinson, arguably the best all-around back. He says, you know what, just call me a running back. You don't have to say that all-around stuff, but a couple of years ago, he caught 100 passes, so he does everything.
He has excellent hands. He could block. He could pick up the blitz. But what I really enjoyed about spending time, and I know the coach and I talked about this afterwards, he did not talk about himself. He talked about one thing. He looked at the coach's ring, and he said, I want one of those. He wants to be a world champion.
You see what he's done against the Raiders. Josh talked about it earlier, almost 122 yards a game. His career high of 243 came against the Raiders as well. Second down and six. Here he comes again. Straight into the middle of things. And he's about 2 yards shy of the first down to the 37-yard line. We talked a little bit about it earlier. Marcus McNeil, the left tackle for the Chargers, is a rookie out of Auburn. Now, he's not rookie size. There he is, 73. 6'7", 336. But I tell you, when you start a football game with a quarterback who's never started and a rookie left tackle, that can be a disastrous combination.
It could be, but they think this guy is going to mature much quicker than the normal rookie left tackle. He's going to have to tonight because he's on Tyler Brayton, and Brayton is one of those intense kids that just keeps coming. He'll catch.
Chargers have had six plays. LaDainian Tomlinson has been involved in five. Make it 6 out of 7. Left side, first down and more. Tripped up as he got down to about the 27-yard line. Stu Schweigert from the secondary got him. But
you were talking about Marcus. Watch the left tackle, number 73, pull. He gets around there. He's going to kick out on the defender right there. Gets up in inside there, and there goes number 21. You know, yesterday was the first time I've ever been around him that I liked him. I was going to coach against him. How could you like a guy that good when you have to coach against
him? That was rookie on rookie because he blocked Michael Huff, the rookie safety out of Texas, who's making the start tonight for the Raiders.
You could not even see Michael Huff. No, he was engulfed.
Nickel in defensively for the Raiders. Eighth play of the Charger drive. First down at the 28-yard line. Tomlinson again.
They may want to get out of that nickel a little bit earlier than they normally like to. Yep. They used it a lot last year, too, but San Diego's going to run the ball on second long.
We talked with LT extensively yesterday about the fact he didn't touch the football in the preseason. He's touching it a lot right now.
He said it didn't make any difference because Marty's football practices are intense.
Right.
On the padded days, you know, they don't tackle in full speed, but everything else they do with quick movement, you know, very intense, and so he feels game ready.
He's caught a pass. He's rushed it that many times. It's a second down and 5 upcoming. He said the only thing about not handling it in the preseason is you worry about ball security because you're really not been hit that hard as far as holding on to the football. Timeout taken by the Chargers, much like the Raiders did on their opening drive. Phillip Rivers doesn't want to waste an opportunity. They have a golden one to score when we come back to Oakland after this. 5:20 remaining first quarter. Raiders had an opening march that stalled right near midfield. The Chargers now have moved it down to the Raider 22-yard line on their opening drive. And they've got a second down and 5. And it has been the LaDainian Tomlinson show so far.
And they're going to keep running the ball, I think, when you play a nickel defense against these guys, especially on second and 5.
Yeah, Derek Gibson, a safety, number 36, is playing a linebacker position.
End around again. Whoops, loose football. Rivers going to go down for a loss at the 29-yard line. Well, they already used the end around to Parker once. They came back to it that time, a missed exchange, unless it was supposed to be a fake handoff and they just made contact with each other. But at any rate, it backs them up to third and long.
Well, you'll see the reverse right here with Parker coming around. And
elbow down.
Elbow down. Boy, that's football 101. The first thing you teach a guy is if the ball coming to your side, get that elbow up.
I know, but wide receivers don't go through running back drills.
That's true.
You know, they really don't. And those fundamentals aren't ingrained. As simple as that may seem, that's a bad, bad mistake.
Chargers were about 42% on third down a year ago. They've got a third and long here. Third and 12. Rivers has thrown one pass and completed it. You assume he's going to put another one up here. Nope. LaDainian Tomlinson on the pitch, and he goes down after a gain of about a yard.
Well, with the field goal kicker they've got, you know,
Nick Kading, yeah, he can bomb him from here.
Marty's playing that role for Cherby.
And I don't blame him. You've got a young quarterback in his first NFL start. You're in third and a long, third and 14, 15. It is the toughest down in football for any quarterback.
You know what I would like about this? Nick Kading's going to be kicking it right where the infield meets the grass.
It can be tough.
I was down in the field earlier, and although it's very firm, you're right. It's right on the seam.
Well, he hit it right down the middle anyway. So the Chargers score on their opening drive. Nate Kading on a field goal. San Diego, a 3-0 lead with just under 4 minutes to go first quarter. Here's Kappa, 51-yard drive and 11 plays. Nate Kading with a 47-yard field goal. They used a little over 6 minutes. There's Charlie Whitehurst, the backup quarterback. He's a rookie out of Clemson. So you got two ACC guys, one a third-year pro who's never started a game, and a rookie behind him, and that's it.
You know, I watched him on the practice field Friday. He's impressive. Now, we haven't seen him in this kind of environment.
Right.
But on a practice field, Ron, you would have liked him.
Rashard Lee and Chris Carr are back deep for Wedding Kading's kick. It'll be Carr, a line drive. He takes it to 10. Trying to get outside. Nice return out across the 30, out to the 32-yard line. 22-yard kick return. So Randy Moss still hasn't gotten his hands on it. He's going to be looking for it from Aaron Brooks, his quarterback, when the Raiders take over on offense. Same thing to a car out here in the... it might have been that guy.
Yeah, I think it was your car.
Yeah, I thought Halloween was in October.
So now the Raiders work from their own 32-yard line. Aaron Brooks at quarterback, two tight ends set. And whistles will blow this one dead. Penalty markers down.
Drayton Florence was jumping at.
Oh, yeah.
False start. Number 76 offense. Five-yard penalty. First down.
And that's Robert Gallery, the left tackle, making his first start over there. Randy Moss, they didn't go to him at all in the first drive. We take a look at a couple of the plays.
Well, Quentin Jammers in real good coverage right there. I don't like what Moss does right here. Quentin Jammers looking back in the backfield. He sees the ball thrown. Moss throws his hands up. He's showing up the quarterback. He was open after Jammer left him when he saw the quarterback, Brooks, release the ball.
You quarterbacks are a little sensitive.
Yeah,
very sensitive. First and 15.
We all worked up here already.
Here's a toss to Jordan.
Great job by Merriman.
And great job
by Merriman.
Wow.
He just stayed with it and just... blasted him out of bounds.
Knees bent, shoulder pads, square, you know, and just worked inside out of the play, and boom, took it right to the sideline. Can't play it any better. You'll see this. Here he is, number 56, the right side of your screen. Big, this Walker, that tackle is about 340 pounds. Played beautifully.
Merriman, a 268-pound linebacker. That just ain't fair. Consensus NFL Defensive Rookie of the Year last season. He is something special.
He was interesting talking to.
He sure was.
Took up boxing there offseason, better condition in his body.
Doesn't like getting better. He talked about that a lot with us. Jordan broke one tackle and got back over the original line of scrimmage out to about the 25-yard line. And already a couple of boo birds out there looking for the football in the air. They'll probably see it here, but it's third down and a mile.
But Brad, that's the right call in that situation. You got a second and long situation. You don't need to get it all. Try to get a positive play out of it. The worst thing you want to do is keep Aaron Brooks in those long-yarded situations where the defense, particularly this great pass-rushing defense of the Chargers, can kick back and attack the quarterback.
Three wideouts now as Ronald Curry comes out with Whitted and Moss on a third and 17. Brooks pressured. Just going to try to get rid of it. And the Raiders will have to give it up.
Yeah, with the penalty, got him in the hole.
Yep.
The most penalized team in football. And what Tart say he's going to do? We're going to eliminate those penalties. Every time in training camp there was a penalty, he made the player run a lap. Well, I think Gallagher, they're going to have to run some laps out this afternoon.
They had 147 penalties last year. That's over 9 a game, and that's 3 straight years they led the league in penalties. You start giving up the length of a football field every time you play, you're not going to win many games.
Not many.
Shane Leckler to punt.
Ooh.
Nice kick by Leckler.
Yep.
And flag down.
Flag.
Well, this one's going to go in Oakland's favor as Parker fields it, and he's got a good return going. It's going to be for naught, though.
That's Polk, the outside linebacker. Carlos Polk came up inside, and I don't know if he got blocked into the kicker, if they'll call it roughing the kicker or running into him. It's up to the official to make that distinction.
Bill Levy's going to tell us in just a second. It was fourth and 17.
First down now. Isn't
it? Well, if it's a five-yarder, the garden variety, it'll be fourth down again. If it's 15 yards, I think it'll still be fourth in a couple yards, Coach.
He's telling Art what it's about here.
Running into the kicker, number 52. Defense, penalties declined. First down, San Diego.
So the Chargers, the penalty declined. We'll take another look at it.
Very good acting, I might add.
I was going to say, that's pretty good.
It looked worse up here than down there.
I guess that would be called rolling under the kicker.
Sliding into the instep, something like that. To the 34-yard line, better field position to start for the Chargers this trip than their first time around.
And clearly, you know, Cam Cameron, the offensive coordinator, sticking with the run. Four straight runs on first down in their opening drive.
Let's see if they keep that going. Antonio Gates, their all-pro tight end in motion. And Adrian Tomlinson off the right side, into the secondary. Tomlinson down the sideline. One man to beat. Knocked out of bounds, but not before he got all the way down to the 4-yard line.
Great, simple, old, fundamental off-tackle run, Ron.
Boy, they just gashed. They just gashed
to the right side of your screen.
Yep.
Kick out, lead block. Great block there by Lorenzo Neal, 41. Blocked by the wide receiver downfield. Poor tackling. Great run. There's the block, 41 right there on Thomas Howard, 53.
They actually mark him out at about the 8. First and goal for the Chargers. Tomlinson again. Stops. There's a little jitter step in the hole and picks up what he can, maybe a yard or two. He's got 90 yards already.
Lorenzo Neal is responsible for a lot of the yards this guy makes all through the season. He is a brute. He's played on 6 football teams, and each football team, they brought him there to do one thing, block for a great running back.
And you know, 9 straight years, whoever's been behind him has been a 1,000-yard rusher or better.
Yeah. 14 years in the NFL, taking on linebackers. I'll tell you, that is one tough hombre.
That's why he has a short neck.
He still looked good in the suit when he did the lineups. Second and goal at the 6. Tomlinson trying to stiff arm his way out.
Good
He's
job.
Going to be dropped back at the 9. Loss of about 3. Asamoah, the corner on that side, made the stop.
Real good inside-out pursuit by the defense. He couldn't get turned up. They forced him back to the sideline, and here comes the corner to make the play. He proved he can tackle. See, he didn't want to run up there. He didn't want to go outside. He had to.
And Howard did a good job as well of stretching LaDainian out and allowed Asamoah to come up and make the play. We got that
third
word, Coach. Asamoah.
You got it. Right, Third down back at the 9. Antonio Gates, last year their all-pro tight end, had 8 catches in the red zone. 7 of them were touchdowns. Just keep that in mind. He's number 85, and he moves out into a slot on the right side. Phillip Rivers takes a timeout. So the Chargers use their second one of the ballgame.
See, with a kid, he's been playing a while. That's his 6-1.
Now they've got it third and goal at the 9. Gates again sets up in a slot on the right side, and Rivers in the gun for the first time tonight. Rivers flares it out. It's the tight end, but it's not Gates, and he didn't quite get there. Got to the 1-yard line. Manu Maluima, the big guy, 288-pound, the other tight end.
They got him from the Rams for a 4th-round pick. He's a blocking guy. Big, strong, physical son of a gun. It takes a couple guys to get him down. Look at 3 guys.
You know, Fabian Washington, who put the shoulder in there, Dick, is down and injured, and they're taking him out. So when he hit that 288-pound tight end, he bounced off. The tight end did, and Washington didn't.
But again, you got to like the decision-making of Phillip Rivers. He's in the pocket. He didn't force the ball to the end zone. He saw Manu Maluima on the perimeter, dumped it off to him.
Will the Chargers get a touchdown on the first snap of the second quarter? We'll find out when we come back. At the 1-yard line. As we start the second quarter, San Diego leading Oakland 3-0. An extra lineman comes in for the Chargers. They'll go for it on 4th down just inside the 1. Tomlinson had a career-high first quarter. Let's see if he touches it to start the second. He does. Airborne touchdown.
He made it.
San Diego in the end zone. And they're going to lead 9-0 with the extra point coming up.
Good call by Marty. You know, there have been times even in my career I've gone the other way.
Right. And I'll tell you what, you know, we call LT Superman. He looked like Superman there. He got about 6 feet in the air, got over the pile, and got it in the end zone.
1 yard touchdown. Last year he had 18 touchdowns on the ground, a career high. So he's off to a tremendous start here in the first 15 minutes and 3 seconds.
Oh, really?
Wow. I mean, wow.
Wow. I still can't figure out why the Raiders were playing with five defensive backs against them. They get a linebacker out.
Extra point by Canning's up and good.
Well, that was part of their scheme all the time last year as well.
Yeah.
Another good-looking drive. Covered 66 yards in only five plays. Most of it done by that guy. And then the capper was, as Jaws said, Superman airborne in for the touchdown. Chargers on the road in Oakland, leading the Raiders 10-0. Kessler, Dick Vermeil, Ron Jaworski, Bonnie Bernstein with you. Sold out crowd as Art Schell makes his return to the sideline. Second tour of duty as the Raider head man. And now he is down 10-0 to the Chargers. And Marty Schottenheimer, who's got more wins against the Raiders than any coach in football. Fading to kick, and Carr will take it on the 8-yard line. Chris Carr looking for an avenue up the sideline, and he's got one. And he's out across the 45-yard line. Good-looking return.
Good return, lousy kick.
LaDainian Tomlinson, great first quarter. And Bonnie, he really loves playing against the Raiders.
You know, it's just yet another example of how successful Tomlinson has been in his career against the Raiders. Last year in October, he actually pulled off the hat trick. He caught a touchdown, and then he ran a touchdown. And we're used to seeing that, but you know we're not used to? Yeah, he actually throws for touchdowns, too. And in LT form, he really had no clue what was going on until somebody pointed it out. He said, yeah, I guess it'll be something nice I could tell my grandkids when I get older.
His career passing numbers, 3 out of 4, 47 yards, 3 touchdowns. I told him there's some quarterbacks not that good. And Aaron Brooks is finding things very tough. Sacked by Luis Castillo back at the 37-yard line. The first sack of the
night. Brought the pressure off the corner there.
Well, what's happening, you're seeing Aaron Brooks drop deep into the pocket using this 7-step drop. And I tell you what, they're just coming off the edge, getting good angles to break Aaron Brooks down. He had no shot because downfield coach, to combine a 7-step drop, you're running routes at 15 to 20 yards.
Plus, if the running backs are going to pick up the linebackers, you better get up closer to the line of scrimmage. They're already in your face.
Well, this is a coaching clinic for you tonight.
No, not really, but you know that.
Castillo and Merriman are probably going to share that sack, I think. And now it's second down and 18. And the Raiders have to run the ball to get some of it back. They pick up about 4. And still, the third down and long situation they wanted to stay out of. And they did on their opening drive. But they haven't been able to stay out of it the last two times they've had the ball. And still nothing to number 18.
13 plays, not a look to number 18 yet.
Mm-hmm. Their third down efficiency last year was really poor. It hurt them, you know. And, that's the problem. If you're going to run the ball, you're going to have more third down situations. Normally get 12 to 13 a game. If you're running a lot and not running well, and you're not throwing well, you're going to end up with more third down.
Well, we haven't seen that Art Schell commitment to the run yet.
Third down at 14. Randy Moss is in a slot on the left side. And Aaron Brooks takes the timeout. I don't know that I've seen 2 timeouts taken by each team in a first half this early in a long time. Brooks will trot to the sideline. A big third down and long coming up for the Raiders when we come back. Last year, Tom Walsh was running a bed and breakfast in Idaho with his wife Ann. Now he's back as offensive coordinator of the Raiders, and he's got another third and long. Sometimes it's not how long you have it, it's what you do with it when you have it. They've only got 22 yards.
Brad, I agree. Here's the key. You look at the number of plays right there. The Chargers have only had 3 more plays. Time of possession, pretty close. But look at the yards right here. That was huge.
This is the third, maybe the fourth time they've had third down and more than 10. Third and 14. Penalty markers down. Brooks down again. Just got swarmed under. Sean Merriman again coming around the corner, and he has been a monster so far.
And he's also was offside.
That's what the flag's going to be
offside.
About.
Number 56 defense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat third down.
You know, he'd probably take that 5 yards just because he got a chance to hit Brooks again. It's still going to be third and long.
Woo. Yeah, he beat the count.
Gallery's going.
He beat the count and the tackle.
But Coach, you know, we had this discussion. A lot of quarterbacks will tip. A lot of centers will tip. And we saw the center on that particular thing, Jake Grove, who was kind of pointing out. He put his hand down. Then the ball was snapped. When you do your film study, you look for every tip you can. Merriman may have gotten a tip from Grove on that play. Jumped it a little bit quick, though.
Let's see if Aaron Brooks looks to Randy Moss for the first time tonight. Third down and 9. Brooks may not have time to find anybody. And down he goes again at the 45-yard line. Castillo is there. So is Merriman.
This guy is a man.
He's the best young defensive lineman I've seen come out since coming back into coaching in 97 from Northwestern. He is very intense, very agile, and he's never knocked off his feet.
And again, Randy Moss looking for the football. Shane Leckler in to punt again. Second straight three and out for the Raiders. Eric Parker waits on the other end, and he'll take it at the 16. Got by the first wave and almost got 10 yards out of the return. So with a 10-point lead, Chargers have got the ball back. Next week, ESPN's Monday Night Football. So the Chargers come back out. Fabian Washington, by the way, was shaken up. Down inside the 5 on the last drive for the Chargers, is back out there at cornerback for the Raiders. Chargers haven't passed yet on first down. Now they will. Well, just in the ground. It was supposed to be a screen to Tomlinson, and that blew up, and Rivers just got rid of it.
Yeah, I think Terdell Sands, number 90, defensive lineman, smelled the screen, went over there. Rivers did a real good job of just laying the ball on the ground.
Absolutely right, Coach. You'll see number 90, Terdell Sands, right there. He grabs... he grabs up and throws him out the way.
You're not going to the screen.
You're not getting to that screen. Good job of understanding what the offense was trying to do. Set up the screen, tackle the running back.
He's big enough to eat the running back at 6'7", 345 pounds.
Second down and 10 for the Chargers. Phillip Rivers, the handoff to Tomlinson. Only a yard and a half, maybe.
Another good play by Higgins. Yeah, another good play. Big, strong guy. We drafted him in the 7th pick a few years back, and he ended up being a practice squad for a year and that kind of stuff, and eventually didn't go. It was just a matter of time and being patient with a great big guy like this. You'll see him there, right there on the center's nose, working there. He's playing it straight away, and bang, gets him down. Did a nice job. Just takes time for those big guys to mature, and he played very little college football, 1 year.
Looks like a passing situation for Phillip Rivers. They haven't tried to throw one to Gates or McCardell yet. And it's Antonio. Gates in motion as Rivers fires, and he got it
great
complete.
Job.
All the way out to the 45-yard line.
Beautiful double move by Keenan McCardell. This guy is like a convenience store. He's open 24-7. You know, he's everything he does. You know, he doesn't have great speed, but that time he ran a double move route. Step, watch it, and we didn't get to see the very first part of that.
Coach, how about
well
the
done.
Throw? Don't forget the quarterback. Watch the double move.
Here it is. There's the first move.
Fabian Washington, good position, but look at the timing of the route.
Beautiful.
Excellent anticipation by Phillip Rivers. I also like the design. They move Phillip Rivers out of the pocket with the roll to buy some time to let the route develop deeper down the field.
Michael Turner getting a carry and got about a yard. Keenan McCardell, that 18-yard pickup on the last play you saw in his 15th year out of UNLV. The only other offensive player still around from that draft is Brett Favre. And now he's got 826 receptions. That's 10th all-time. And as you can see, he's got a streak going that started a long time ago. He's an awfully good football player that not a lot of people recognize.
And a great leader within the organization as well.
Second and 9. He goes out to the left side.
We got a linebacker down on the bottom of the screen spread out down there. See this?
Rivers looks, fires deep for Gates. Got him down to the 32-yard line. And that's the dimension that tight end brings to the game, a pickup of 22.
See, the formation used forced the defense in a tight situation over there. They had receivers spread out, fullback over to the sideline, out of the backfield, puts him in a one-on-one situation over there, and he's going to win most of those battles.
And Michael Huff is a 4-3 safety. This guy can play corner safety, and Gate just whoops him. But I love, again, the anticipation of Phillip Rivers. Can I say Drew who?
Not yet.
Not yet? All right.
Three plays ago, I said he hadn't looked for McCardell or Gates, and the last three plays, both those guys have their hands on it. Now it's LaDainian Tomlinson off the left side again. And inside the 30, down to about the 28-yard line. Speaking of Drew Brees, we mentioned earlier, he's a starter with New Orleans after leaving 20 wins and a 96-plus rating. First time ever that somebody's won 20 games and been over 90 as a quarterback rating over 2 years, and then they get rid of you. Of course, he had the shoulder injury in the season finale. He signed as a free agent with the Saints. If he wasn't in New Orleans, Aaron Brooks wouldn't be starting here. Phillip Rivers might not be starting for the Chargers either. But Drew and Phillip Rivers had a conversation a couple days ago on the phone. We'll talk about that as we go. So yeah. Far, Phillip, 4 out of 5.
They remain great friends, which is very important.
On second down, play action. Rivers steps up, trying to buy himself some time, and now he gets down, gets what he can, and got to about the 25-yard line. You know, Jaws, you started in what, your second year?
My third year.
And Dick, you've been around a lot of quarterbacks. This is kind of the way it should be. Learn from a guy and then come in.
And he liked the whole concept. He didn't fight the concept. He had a good attitude about it. He has a new quarterback coach in John Lansdale, who was with me for 3 years in the Rams, with Mike Martz. He knows how to coach those quarterbacks. And this guy has poise. I could sense that Marty and the offensive staff really don't worry about him. They have confidence in him.
Third down at 3. Rivers, little shovel pass inside. I don't think it's going to be enough. Yep. It'll be about a yard short. Kirk Morrison knocked LaDainian Tomlinson off his feet. You saw that graphic about the quarterbacks starting a season with a quarterback and a backup that had never started in a game. The Panthers with Chris Wenke and Damian Craig and Matt Lytle were the team that started a season a few years back that didn't have any experience at that signal calling position. And now Nate Kading, who's already hit one field goal of 47 yards, is going to line one up from 42. Trying to stretch the San Diego lead. 3 more. And this one, he missed. Off to the right.
Flag down.
Penalty marker down.
Running into the kicker, number 21 defense, 5-yard penalty, results in a first down.
You know, this is what Art Shell is trying to fight and trying to change, giving an opponent a penalty, a possible scoring drive. They did it 25% of the opponent's scoring drive last year.
25% kept the drive alive?
Gave them a penalty, first down, kept the drive alive for a score.
25% of the time? 25% of the time. That's incredible.
71 opponent drives, 18 first down penalties.
We saw this yesterday, running into the punter or roughing the punter penalty between the Broncos and the Rams, gave the Rams life, and they subsequently went on to win the ball game. Here already the Raiders are at a 10-0 hole. Asim was the guy that ran in to Kading, and that's first down, and Tomlinson an opening on the left side, and he's inside the 15-yard line. Stuart Schweiger got him down, but he picked up 6 more yards. And he is at 100, fellas.
Here they run it toward the wing back, and they seal off the defense, lead by the fullback, cut back, pull out that tackle, and here he goes up inside.
Marcus McNeil at 6'7", 336. The young fella looks agile getting around the corner.
Well, that 288-pound tight end over there doesn't hurt.
That's right.
LT, 100 yards on 14 totes. That's not counting his pass receptions. 29th, 100-yard plus game. Second down, a long 4 for the Chargers, threatening again, already leading 10-0. Tomlinson looking for a little bit of opening on the inside. Tough sledding there. Lance Johnstone made the stop for the Raiders. We're under 7 minutes. San Diego controlling the football game, controlling the clock, and doing it with number 21.
It's about how we expected this game to play out. San Diego try to control the clock, control the time of possession, keep Randy Moss and his big playability on the sideline. But right now, this Raider defense, they've got to bow their backs, and they have got to make a stop. They've got to slow down the momentum of the San Diego Chargers.
Remember, they forced a field goal that Kading missed. Now they'd like to force him into another one. This is a 6-minute drive.
They're in an unbalanced line over to the left side. Really loaded up. It didn't help him.
And they did stop Lorenzo Neal. Kyle Brayton made the tackle.
You'll see they had more people on the left side of the formation than the right. A legal formation. But normally you're trying to load up and get more people. You'll see this from the left side. See over here? You got a lot of people over there.
Well, they had number 70, Shane Olivier, who's normally the right tackle, move over on the left side, and the tight end came to the right side. So they have what a lot of teams call that heavy formation.
We called it elephant.
Nate Kading missed his 42-yarder. He's going to get a try of 29 here, and he has hit his last 17 field goals inside 40 yards. Made his first one, missed, and now he's got another chance. They're going to take another timeout, and that's it for the timeouts. Shane Olivier, I think, had a problem with his helmet. They'll get that straightened out, loving so vividly. From 5 years ago, Nate Kading, 29-yard field goal attempt, up and good. So it's 13 to nothing with 5:36 remaining. And the Raiders are going to have to get something going offensively for Art Schell when we come back to Oakland in a minute. The San Diego Chargers have scored on their first three possessions, and they lead the Oakland Raiders 13 to nothing with 5:36 remaining in the first half. Nate Kading, who just hit the field goal, will tee it up as he had a second opportunity. Missed one, but after the penalty, he had a chip shot from 29 to give him the 13-point lead. Chris Carr had a nice return the last time he got his hands on it. He waits for the Raiders back at the goal line.
That's a better kickoff this time.
Carr will take it at the 5. Across the 20. And out to about the 26-yard line. Well, Aaron Brooks so far, Jaws, has had a heck of a time getting anything going for the Raiders offensively.
Well, Wade Phillips, the defensive coordinator, has a tremendous scheme based out of his 3-4 defense, 3 down line and 4 linebackers. They love to slant, twist, and stunt to free guys up. You see, here they bring the linebackers from the outside. The push up the middle, they wreak havoc on the quarterback. Brooks right here is having a tough time getting a comfortable cradle to throw from.
He's only 1-for-4 for 9 yards, and he's been sacked twice. There's Wade Phillips, the defensive coordinator of the Chargers. First down, Oakland from its own 26-yard line. Randy Moss still hasn't touched the football. And now he has. And he's run out of bounds after a pickup of about 5. You know, when he was with the Vikings, they used plays like that where he caught balls near the line of scrimmage. They really hadn't utilized him like that last year in Oakland.
Well, that was a running play. That was just a side adjustment. I think the quarterback saw the people up there right where he was going to run the football. So he either what you call it, old smoke or whatever, just boom, threw it out there to him. He hitched it. He got more than he would have run the ball.
Right on, coach. A running play was called. The corner gave a big cushion. Moss just turned around. Brooks stood up and threw him the football. Finally got the ball in Randy Moss's hands.
And a pickup of 5. Chargers showing blitz. They're going to go right back to the same thing. And first down for Randy Moss. And he gets out across the 40 to the 42-yard line. So they did basically the same thing, a pickup of 10. And here it is again.
Yeah, you'll see it right here. It's a running play. You see both those backs coming to that side. So Brooks just stands up and throws him the ball. You know, the corner gives this kind of cushion. Look at that cushion. Hey, take it. Take the positive play. Now what San Diego's going to have to adjust, bring that corner up, maybe roll the safety over the top. Well, all of a sudden, now you're running in 7 of box. Better opportunity to run the football with Lamont Jordan.
First down at the 41-yard line. Brooks deep drop this time. Look out. Scrambles out of the pocket. Now he's got a lot of green in front of him. Across midfield. And he's got a first down. Nice run by Aaron Brooks.
You know, it's obvious that Wade Phillips has decided to pressure him on these rundowns and get him in long yards. Again, see, they're bringing linebackers to the left side of your screen. They didn't pick him up properly. He's out there flushed and running, and he's going to make some yards. This is one of the best things this guy does. He can run the football, and he's hard to sack. He really is.
He did a nice job of feeling that pressure. No one opened downfield. So far, he's been judicious with the football, not making a big mistake and taking the run opportunity when it's there.
Judicious. Well, first coach, you couldn't pronounce that.
He still can't spell it.
Oh, man, you guys are rough.
14 for Brooks on that scramble. Now he's firing to the outside, completes it out, and it's Randy Moss again. So Moss has 3 catches on this drive, a pickup of 12 and another first down.
Good protection allowed him to throw this ball.
One-on-one situation. Yep, singled up here on Quentin Jammer. Moss pushing hard, really good stem, threatens Quentin Jammer deep, does a nice job of coming back. Good offset throw by Brooks.
With that kind of defensive corner technique where you turn to the inside and run, you're going to guarantee you don't get deep, but it's hard to cover the out patterns.
You turn your shoulders parallel that sideline, there's no way you can come out of that break.
This is a really important drive for Art Schell and the Raiders offense. They trail 13 to nothing. They look sharp so far as they marched it down to the 33. Here comes a blitz. Brooks stands in. Now he goes down in a heap.
He's got to see that. He's got to see those guys coming. He knows he does not have that time.
Sean Phillips and Donnie Edwards are there to combine on the sack, the third of the night.
Good job. Here they come to the left side of the screen, and right up in the middle, they got a one-on-one situation. Cross-charge it. Bang. Donnie Edwards, good job.
And the problem is you got Randy Moss running a deep corner out. That's going to take 3.1 seconds, and right now Brooks is just not getting that kind of time.
Moss is going to take a walk to the sideline.
I wonder if they have a three-step drop passing philosophy.
We haven't seen it yet.
Scheme. Yeah. Slants and crossing pattern, just, you know, get the ball out of the backfield quickly.
Brooks back to throw on second and 17. Across the middle, completes it. Oh, in and out of the hands, or did he fumble it? It's going to be incomplete. It was Courtney Anderson, the tight end, who couldn't hold it. Let's get a 30-30 update. Here's Carl Ravitch. Carl?
Hi, Brad. Baseball fans in San Diego know the Padres lead the wild card race. They're concerned about the Marlins. Sanibel Sanchez follows your game mobile ESPN alerts all the time.
All right, Carl, thanks. Third down and long. Brooks
Merriman
in trouble again.
Merriman, 1-1, just ate him a lump. Eight galleries lunch coming around the outside.
Oh, boy, and he's got the bull going.
The problem is, Coach, you're getting in third and 15, third and 17. You're very limited in what you can do. You
left
have to go
screen
to the deep drop. Check it out right there. Gallery just can't handle the speed and quickness of Merriman off the edge. Woof! Watch it right here. Game speed. You try to block this guy. What, are you kidding me? Still working hard. He makes the play. That boxing. That was that boxing right there. You know, that quick jab, and boom, he's in the backfield.
Muay Thai.
Who?
That's his martial arts thing that's got the boxing going on.
Muay Thai.
2-minute warning. They need Muay offense. The Raiders do. It's 13-0 Chargers. LaDainian Tomlinson has been the offense. Sean Merriman's been the defense. And the Chargers lead the Raiders 13-0. And Art Schell's return to the Oakland sideline as a head coach hasn't been pretty for the fans who came out here in full force. And they've been here a couple of days, a lot of them. Haven't seen what they were looking for. Shane Leckler will have to punt again.
This guy's one of the best punters in football, if not the best.
The guy in the stands or Leckler?
Leckler. He's the pooch punter here. Now he's going to try to drop that inside.
Parker will field it at the 12 and get buried.
Good coverage.
1:51 remaining here. Don't forget, next week, ESPN's Monday Night Football. Chargers with a big lead. They're in a hole here. Not good field position at their own 12-yard line, but they lead 13-0.
And Randy Moss cheering his team on. He was voted by his teammates to be the offensive captain.
LaDainian Tomlinson, one of the first times tonight, he's been stopped for no gain or very little, and he has a few words with the defense. Let's check in with Bonnie.
Well, I'll tell you what, Brad, if there's somebody in the Randy Moss has really matured camp, it is Art Schell. You guys talked about he was voted the team captain. And while Schell has heard all of the give me the ball rumors, he hasn't heard any of that. He says Moss has been the model citizen. He's worked his butt off. If he's missed around in practice, he'll be the first one to say, hey, this one's on me. It won't happen again. And if one of the other guys slacks off, he'll get on their butt. So, you know, this is only week one. Let's keep that in mind. But so far, so good as far as the relationship between Art Schell and Randy Moss.
On second and long, Michael Turner getting some work, and he gets it out to the 20-yard line. Turner doesn't get a lot of work when you're playing behind LaDainian Tomlinson, but last year he had over 300 yards, averaged almost 6 yards a carry, and scored 3 touchdowns. LT getting a little bit of a breather and a well-deserved one.
Yeah, Marty Schottenheimer told me this guy is really a fine football player. He says eventually he doesn't think he'll be able to keep him because he'll go off and be somebody else's starter. But, you know, in his career, he's carried the ball 77 times for a 5.7 average and 3 touchdowns. He's a fine football player.
Raiders have taken their last timeout with 56 seconds remaining, hoping to force a punt here and a third down upcoming and trying to get the football back.
And there's a fine football coach. You got to play for him. I got to follow him in Kansas City. That's a tough act to follow.
I played for Marty in 1989, and I got to tell you something. He gets all lathered up
for the Raiders.
He has been very successful at beating the Raiders. But, boy, I tell you, you know it's Raider week. You know, Marty would come in the locker room on Saturday before the game, and, you know, you don't need a game plan. You don't need that. This is going to be a tough physical battle. It's not going to be X's and O's. Hit him in the mouth. That's right, because that's how the Raiders are going to play you.
See if the Raiders can stop the Chargers on third down and 2. It's Turner, and they don't stop him. He's still going forward. out across the 25 and a first down, and so the Chargers can do no worse than a 13-0 lead at halftime, unless they put the ball on the ground. Coming up at the half, Stuart Scott and Mike Ditka will have the Lexus halftime show for you. They'll have the latest, including the Vikings win over the Redskins, news around the NFL. Carl told you about the trade today. Seattle getting Deion Branch. Tonight's Major League Baseball action and a lot more. Stu and the coach coming up on the Lexus halftime show. So we're down probably to the final play of the first half as the Chargers are going to take a knee. Phillip Rivers in his first start hasn't been asked to do a lot. The reason being number 21's in his backfield and has had a huge first half. And Governor Schwarzenegger ready for some football. So's a packed house here at McAfee Coliseum in Oakland. But the San Diego Chargers, the visitors, on top, 13-0. As a matter of fact, Governor Schwarzenegger is going to be joining us here in the third quarter. Welcome back, everybody. Brad Nessler, Dick Vermeil, Ron Jaworski. Fellas, impressions of the first half right now. San Diego's defense playing very well.
Well, I think San Diego's big people, offensive linemen and defensive linemen, are dominating the ballgame. Positive for them. Raiders are having a tough time.
Aaron Brooks is really having a tough time.
And that's the key. Tom Walsh, the offensive coordinator for the Raiders, has been away from football for 7 years. We're going to find out in the second half if he has the ability to adjust, because his tackles are having a tough time. He's going to have to keep a tight end to help those tackles out, or a back end on their side to chip.
They finally, in that last drive, went to Randy Moss. He had three catches before coming out and talked on the sideline with Art Shell. The story offensively tonight, though, has not been Moss. It's been the guy that we expected it to be. LaDainian Tomlinson, who has been sensational, had over 100 yards rushing in the first half. So we open up the second half, and drop of the ball at the goal line is Michael Turner, but he regains possession and he gets out and goes down to the 20-yard line. Let's check in with Bonnie Bernstein. Bon?
This isn't exactly the way Art Shell envisioned his return to the Raiders, but he said it doesn't matter whether it's the first game, the second game, the 15th game. There's absolutely nothing that my team's doing well. No specifics, just wants to see better overall play. On the Chargers side, Marty Schottenheimer, not particularly pleased with his offense. LT's got his numbers, but he says we're settling for field goals and instead of finishing off our drives. Phillip Rivers, they want to gradually move him into things. What times he's thrown, Schottenheimer's been pleased with him.
Empty backfield right now. Now Tomlinson and Lorenzo Neal both will rejoin Phillip Rivers behind the first start quarterback. And it's Tomlinson. And this is what they need. The Raiders need a stop to open up the third quarter. Let's check the first half numbers. Statistically, you see the rushing yards and almost all of that, LaDainian Tomlinson. Not a lot of passing by either team.
Well, total yards right there by the Oakland Raiders. Not very good. 45 yards only the entire first half.
LaDainian made more than that on one run.
That's exactly right. He had a 58-yard run. Keep in mind, though, the Raiders are only two plays away from having the lead. It is not that far out of reach. 13-0. Second down and 10. Neal in motion back toward the ball. Tomlinson again, and now he's tripped up in the backfield. Michael Huff, the rookie out of Texas, makes the stop.
That's two plays in a row he's made. Two plays in a row, and they're excited about this young first-round pick. Safeties have not been a strong part of Raider defense for a few years. Here he comes on a safety blitz to the outside of the right side of your screen, nails him for a loss. Third and long, let's see how San Diego handles third and long.
You want to stop LaDainian Tomlinson. You must get penetration into the backfield. His worst game a year ago was against the Philadelphia Eagles. They hit him before he got going.
Michael Huff, who made that tackle, wearing number 24. It used to be Charles Woodson. Willie Brown before that. Third and long. Rivers, quick throw. And no flag as the ball was intended for Eric Parker. Fabian Washington had a little bump on him over there, but it's three and out, and the Raiders couldn't ask for anything better. First three and out for the Chargers tonight, as a matter of fact.
They don't have many of them.
Nope.
They were one of the most efficient offenses in football last year. They didn't have as many drives as a lot of teams, but they were more efficient with those drives.
So Cyphers will punt. Chris Carr waiting on the other end. Cyphers was a Pro Bowl alternate a year ago. He only had 26 punts returned all year. That's pretty darn good. This one will be. And Carr got out to the 40-yard line. So good starting field position. 46-yard kick, 5-yard return. Randy Moss set to put the hat on and see what he can do for the Raiders offense as they trail 13-0, but they've got the ball when we come back.
unmatched technology, and innovation years ahead of its time. We've pushed the boundaries of high definition and tested the limits of reality. The new Pure Vision Plasma Display. Only from Pioneer.
I was going to steal some credit card numbers to buy that new Z52 Superfusion telescope to try and see Uranus. Then I realized I could live like some playboy. I mean, look at me. I'm all hot. And when I'm not chilling with my ladies, I'm racing up the sweet Hawaiian coastline. Uranus is cool and all, but I want it all now. Right, Eugene?
Totally.
Rated E10 for ages 10 and up.
This supports full 1080i resolution.
I'm confused.
1080i.
No, I'm confused why it costs so much more here than at Walmart.
Oh, we do offer a rebate. You cut out the UPC code, fill out this form. Do you know origami? You have to fold it, do a badger, an armadillo, mail it, and then 3 to 12 months later, ma'am, could you do a fruit bat? That's easy.
The same brand name HDTVs, except ours have the discounts already built in. Get smart before you buy at walmart.com/HDTV.
This telecast is copyrighted by the NFL for the private use of our audience. Any other use of this telecast or of any pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game without the NFL's consent is prohibited.
ESPN's Monday Night Football is brought to you by the all-new Mazda CX-7, the SUV you never saw coming. Test Drive Unlimited, available for the Xbox 360. Pioneer Pure Vision Plasmas, we push the boundaries of high definition. And the Men's Warehouse, need a suit?
Back at McAfee Coliseum in Oakland, the Raiders trail the Chargers, where they got excellent starting field position after getting a defensive stop on the opening march of the third quarter. So Aaron Brooks will set him up at the 40-yard line. And back to throw he goes, and out completes. That is Randy Moss, a nice move, and Moss has got 15 and more. Tiptoes out of bounds, and he's got a first down in Charger territory, a pickup of 20.
Aaron Brooks does an excellent job of finding the single coverage on Randy Moss and takes advantage of it. Quentin Jammer giving a big cushion. Outstanding anticipation by Brooks. Gets the ball with space for Moss to get upfield.
The officials with a flag down have a conference. It's back there in the defensive secondary. And here's Bill Levy, our head referee, with a call.
Taunting, number 18 of the Raiders. Threw the ball at the opponent in the out-of-bounds area. 15-yard penalty. It'll be first and 10.
Boy,
and go ahead and say it. Right?
Just when something goes right for Randy Moss, he turns around and backfires on it. Get a look at the end of the play. Well, he threw it to Nate Kading. I don't know what that had to do with anything.
I don't see that.
That might be a little weak.
He's taking the rule a little too seriously.
I think so. So now, instead of way down into Charger territory, it's first and 10. It's back at the 45-yard line. Four catches, a lot of them short throws, and Moss has done the rest with a run after the catch. Brooks, here comes the heat again, and down he goes again. That's the fifth sack, and this one's Jamal Williams, the big nose tackle. Well, we welcome the governor of California, Arnold Schwarzenegger, to the booth. We just saw the governor grab the football helmet. You were ready for some football. We're having some pretty good football out here tonight.
This is unbelievable. I think that since Art Shell came back and is the coach, I think this is a miracle performance here today.
Arnold, talk about the NFL trying to get a team back in the state of California, and that was something that Paul Tagliabue wanted to do before he left. Roger Goodell, I'm sure, is going to carry that on. What do you think the latest is there?
Well, I think that we have a good chance. I don't want to just have one extra team. I want to have two teams. I think Anaheim can take one and Los Angeles can take one. I think that you're ready for it. There's a huge audience out there that wants to, you know, watch football, live football. I think it's exciting. It's one of the greatest sports, and I think that we deserve it.
It wouldn't do any good to move one of these two teams, though, would it, into a new market?
No, I think they're in a perfect location. I think we need some new teams, you know, and I think that hopefully that very soon we're going to get the word from them, from the NFL, that we're going to have a new team.
All right. Well, got a third down coming up. We're going to come back to you in just a second. Important third down, but it's a long one.
What else is new? It's been third and long for the Raiders all evening.
Well, this one's third and 16. How many times is this, Dick? Five times at least, third and 10 or more?
It has been.
And it's Brooks. Waits and fires and completes it. And it's not going to be enough for the first down, though, as he got it to about the 49-yard line, a pickup of 11. A lot of the other things around the NFL, Governor, have been talked about, especially with the Balco situation going on around here. The National Football League has talked more about steroid testing or human growth hormone. And I know back in your day, you've admitted that you did that. Your stand on that right now?
Well, I think it's good to do doping tests. And the trick always is to find a way of really doing true testing,
right?
Because the drug companies have an attack for a defense for every attack. So as soon as you have a test, then they have a way around that test. So if you can figure that out, I think it's a good idea. In the meantime, I think it's great to watch football. These are the greatest athletes.
Leckler with a punt, a fair catch by Parker, will be taken at the 10-yard line. A 40-yard punt and no return again, and that's been the story for Leckler for a lot of years. Orrin Sapp, been a long night for him, 13-0 with 11:25 remaining in the third quarter. And the Raiders kind of shaking their heads right now, trying to get something going. Well, I know as we look back, it's the fifth anniversary, as everybody knows, of the tragedy of 9/11, and all of us remember where we were. And Governor, I know you got a special guest up here right after this snap. We're going to come back up here in the booth and talk a little bit with Captain Tim Buckley. First down, meanwhile, for the Chargers at the 10-yard line. Not good starting field position. And it's going to be a gain of about one for LaDainian Tomlinson. I'll let you do the honors, Governor, as we come back in the booth, and you got a special guest up here with us.
Well, as you know, Tim Buckley is one of those courageous firefighters that went when we had the 9/11 tragic terrorist attack. He went from California back there to help those firefighters, and he's a very heroic man. He was back there for a long time helping and really risking his own life to save other lives. So he's one of our great heroes.
Tim, we know that it has obviously changed this country and changed all of us. I guess I just want to ask you how it's changed you over the last 5 years.
Well, you know, it changes a lot of the way we think, and you really think more when you're going to types of calls and what to expect. You don't know what to expect anymore after something like that.
Ed, 5 years ago, what were you thinking this morning when you got out of bed?
5 years ago this morning, I was woken up by one of the other crew members coming in saying one of the planes hit the tower. And then next thing you know, a few hours later, we're packing up to go.
Well, we obviously,
these firefighters are just unbelievable because, you know, it's the most selfless profession, you know, to risk your own lives, to save other lives. I mean, I make a lot of action heroes in my life, but those are the true action heroes.
Isn't that the truth? Third down and six. Pass is incomplete. And that's going to bring up a punting situation for the Chargers. Captain Buckley, we want to thank you.
Thank you.
And all the guys that do the work that you do. Governor,
thank you very much for having us here. Thank
you. Nice to have you up here.
Thank
you. Nice to meet you.
You guys enjoy the rest of the football game.
Absolutely, we will. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Arnold Schwarzenegger, the governor of the state of California, and Captain Tim Buckley, one of the firefighters who helped. And, of course, everybody remembers where they were and what was going on 5 years ago. And the moment of silence we had before the game tonight, the national anthem, you just had this feeling in your stomach. Everybody was holding American flags. And then we had the by the fighter planes. And it was quite a scene here, as I know it was back in Washington for the Redskins and the Vikings game. We got a timeout with 9:53 remaining in the third quarter. It's 13-0, Chargers in front.
Well, I hope Roger found enough firewood.
Yeah, I want to make s'mores.
Hey, guys, I gathered the wood and made a fire.
Oh, yeah, and I built a shelter.
Even as a kid, I believed in giving people a little more than they expected. I'm Roger Riney. I started Scottrade to take care of online investors like nobody else. With $7 trades, no inactivity fees, and personal attention at your local office. Click, call, or stop by Scottrade today.
We advance in leaps and bounds. From generation to generation. At Acura, we help people advance. From where they are to where they could be. Acura. Advance.
Every Sunday, start your NFL weekend. And start it right with NFL Sunday Countdown. Chris Berman, your host for 2 hours of news, information, and updates that will get you ready for a full day of football. Sunday NFL Countdown, presented by IBM, every Sunday at 11 a.m. Eastern Time. Brad Nessler, Dick Vermeil, Ron Jaworski, Bonnie Bernstein with you in Oakland, where the Raiders have good starting field position. Their offense has only run 7 plays in San Diego territory tonight. They work from their own 44-yard line, trailing by 13. And it's Jordan, Lamont Jordan. They have had trouble establishing the run. Quite frankly, they have trouble establishing anything, whereas the Chargers really haven't had that problem because LaDainian Tomlinson had his best first quarter in his brilliant career, 115 total yards and a touchdown. And this has been the big problem for Aaron Brooks. Just a swarming San Diego defense. 5 sacks already, led by Merriman and Castillo and Williams in that game. Let's see if they can hold him out on second down at 6. Here they come. And looking for a place to hide, and they got him again. And it's Merriman. Boy, is he something else.
He is.
But Brad, this offense is not on schedule. You finally had a good first down run of 4 yards. You get in that second down situation, 2nd and 6. Why do you have to drop back? You got to get in that third down situation where you have your entire playbook available. Guys like Merriman has unbelievable quickness, unbelievable agility, jumping over people, tracking Brooks down. You've got to make these guys defend the run as well as the pass. They are not forcing them to play two-dimensional defense.
Wade Phillips, defensive coordinator of the Chargers. His team has really done a number. This is the shortest third down they've had, I think, all night. Brooks back to throw again. Steps and waits and fires, and it's incomplete. The closest guy was Ronald Curry. And they'll have to punt it right back.
You know, and the defense, the Raider defense, has done a real good job the second half. They've come out, shut them down.
Yeah, they have.
3 snaps and out twice. Gained some momentum. Now the offense just got to contribute. They get back in the football game.
And when we spoke with Coach Shell, he talked about winning the real estate, coming off the ball and winning the space that that guy occupies. We haven't seen that physical approach, that attitude style of running. And obviously, you know, I believe they're calling too many of the deep drops in the passing game, and that's allowing that great pass rush, the Chargers, to tee off on them.
Only 1 out of 7 on third down conversions for the Raiders tonight. Leckler. And Parker's going to get out of the way. It's going to be a great kick.
That's
a nice coverage.
Wow, great punt.
Way down at about the 5-yard line. 44-yard kick. It'll be the Chargers in a hole, but they've got the lead and the football when we come back with 8:23 to go in the third.
Lane catches fire. You got 3 choices.
Burn with it all the way to the ground. Jump in several thousand feet. Or you can take the quick way out.
Fly Boys, rated PG-13, starts September 22nd.
So you got the interview. It's on Monday, and it's now Saturday. At Men's Warehouse, our expert tailors can alter your suit in 24 hours and hem your pants while you wait. So relax. You're going to like the way you look. I guarantee it.
Sure looked good on paper. But who's going to help you make sure it looks good on stage?
The NFL and television go back nearly 70 years. This season, NFL Network invites you to a new football tradition, Thursday and Saturday Night Football.
With a telecast you'd expect from NFL Network, made by football people for football people. Great matchups on the run to the playoffs. Join us for a new football tradition.
It all begins Thanksgiving night, only on NFL Network.
Saturday Night Football on ABC. Nebraska versus USC this Saturday at 8.
That group is going to try to make it hard on Phillip Rivers, the Chargers offense, who have huddled in their own end zone. They're going to start at about the 7-yard line is where they finally marked it. Worst starting field position of the night for San Diego. Rivers has handled himself well. They haven't asked him to do that much. because of this guy, Tomlinson. And again, they do a good job of bringing him down.
You know, like Rob Ryan's defense has done a really good job this second half.
Well, Phillip Rivers, we talked a lot about it, making his first career start after sitting behind Drew Brees for 2 years, and two other guys in that class have done pretty well, fellas.
Yeah, you bet. One did pretty well the other day, though he got beat on Monday night.
Of course,
Manning there.
Ben Roethlisberger, the youngest quarterback to win a Super Bowl, over 5,000 yards. Eli lost to Peyton, but he went over the 5,000-yard mark in that game last night. Second down and a long seven. And it's Tomlinson, and he got out to the 12 or 13-yard line. Derek Burgess made the stop, the captain of the defense.
You know, Warren Sapp did a real good job there, Ron. He didn't make the tackle, but he broke up the play.
And also, you mentioned Rob Ryan, the defensive coordinator for the Raiders, has changed his game plan a bit. They're not playing that nickel defense, or they were bringing Burgess in that that secondary form. So now they're playing with their base 4-3, four down linemen, three linebackers.
Let's see if they can stop them again. They have a couple of times already this quarter. Third down. Only one pass thrown to Antonio Gates, and that's a little strange. I'm sure the Raiders know where he is. Third down and four. Tomlinson, safe call, but going nowhere. And the Chargers will have to punt again. Terdell Sands again, along with Warren Sapp. And third, three and out.
Yeah, Marty obviously being very conservative with that call there. Confident his defense can keep playing like they've been playing. Didn't want to take any chances down there deep in his own territory.
And Warren Sapp did an outstanding job of taking on the double team and the trap block and held the point of attack and allowed the linebackers to make the play. Sapp playing well.
Cyphers to punt. Chris Carr should get a pretty good play on this as you look behind Mike Cyphers. High kick, a mile in the air. Carr waiting and waiting and waiting, and no fair catch. He's going to pay the price. Back at the 35-yard line. 49-yard kick with great hang time. Antonio Cromartie, number one draft choice, makes the tackle. See if the Raiders can get the offense in gear when we come back.
Sign up for a free 30-day trial, including calls and nonstop sports, and get a $150 signing bonus.
This hurts more than shopping for auto insurance.
Suck it up, champ. Esurance takes the pain out of it.
But I need collision coverage now.
With some of the fastest quotes on the web, Esurance makes it easy to save on auto insurance.
That's why thousands of drivers switch to Esurance every week.
Esurance has got you covered in every season.
Quote by...
Down. If you're on the go, you gotta have Esurance.
Get your fast, free auto insurance quote. Visit Esurance.com today.
Go back to school in style with an HP Pavilion DV2000T with Intel Centrino Duo Mobile Technology. Stay in touch with an optional webcam or the integrated microphone. Use the optional remote to watch widescreen movies in high definition or listen to music in concert stereo. And it comes with HP's award-winning Total Care, including free 24/7 live chat support for the life of your computer. The HP Pavilion DV2000T. Call 1-800-525-MYHP.
When your time is up, death will find you.
You can't cheat death. The ones who got off that roller coaster are still going to die.
I'm next.
Unless we can figure out how to stop it.
Fasten your seatbelts for Final Destination 3, the ultimate roller coaster ride.
You're dead!
Order it now on DirecTV Pay-Per-View.
The Raider Nation still waiting for the Raiders offense with 6:12 remaining in the third quarter. Brad Nessler, Dick Vermeil, Ron Jaworski, Bonnie Bernstein with you from McAfee Coliseum in Oakland, where the Raiders try to avoid a sixth straight loss to San Diego. Brooks, little draw play, Jordan. And Lamont got out, picked up about 4 yards on the play. Steve Foley, starting linebacker, out for the rest of the season. He'll miss the entire year without pay, at least for now, as a result of several gunshot wounds to his leg, his hand, and his thigh. He suffered after a car chase between himself and an off-duty police officer last week. A very strange story. According to police reports, the off-duty officer started pursuing Foley in the wee hours of September 3rd on suspicion of drunk driving. We'll talk more about that. A lot of his teammates have been honoring him in different ways tonight that only Steve would know about. He's still recuperating in the hospital as Aaron Brooks goes back to throw, and the pass is broken up and almost intercepted by Sean Phillips, Steve Foley's replacement. Let's check in with Bonnie.
Foley just having to turn 31 today, Brad. Probably not the way he imagined spending his birthday. If there is any good news, he got out of ICU a couple of days, and he is listed in fair condition, but to be honest, when I talk to a lot of the players, he's still heavily sedated a lot of the time and isn't in great shape. Everybody seems to be keeping a pretty tight lid on this thing. San Diego County Sheriff's Department said that Foley's blood alcohol test will be back this week. They will continue to gather as the evidence, and then in the next few weeks the DA will decide whether this is going to trial or not.
Bonnie, thanks. Brooks comes up firing, incomplete, another drop pass. Courtney Anderson, the tight end.
He's dropped all three of them.
Coach, you started out the game. What has hurt the Raiders? Yep. Penalties and drop balls. Yeah. That pattern is staying with this game. Aaron made a nice throw there. He stroked it in there. He got to come up with a catch. You know, third and six, you're going to squeeze the ball in the tight areas. Brooks made a great throw, but Anderson did not come up with a catch for the third time.
I want to go back to Steve Foley, guys, just to finish it off. Steve, we know if you're watching the game, we wish you a very quick recovery. You're a very popular player among your teammates, and they all told us that. So good luck recovering. Leckler to kick. Eric Parker back deep. Nice punt. Parker, don't catch that one, son. He's going to take it anyway.
Unbelievable.
He caught that inside the five.
These two punters have been outstanding.
They really have. 58-yard kick.
Number 26,
San Diego still in front, but the score has not changed.
Can anyone tell me what happened to Napoleon when he tried to invade Russia? Brian?
There's quite a beautiful Jack writing about the big game tonight.
Hey, Ryan.
Somebody's going to get their first loss here tonight. It's not going to be us, is it?
No, sir!
Take a knee.
We can take them.
Is that all you got, Locker?
It's all you, Ryan.
You got 22 wide cross. Be open, Ryan.
Gotcha.
We're down. Last chance for the Hawks.
Blue 80. All right, the ball, Ryan. Green in. Gotta go.
He may be the king of talk.
Everything hurts. My hair hurts.
But when it comes to his dancing,
I don't have a prayer.
Words can't describe it. Dancing with the Stars, live 2-hour premiere Tuesday at 8, 7 Central, only on ABC.
On Monday Night Football, the Raiders were so good from 70 to 90. And since then, it's been a struggle. 7-15 from 91 to 05. And, of course, they had some great coaches from 70 to 90 in Super Bowl appearances, and they were the team of the decades. Tonight, they're shut out so far with 5 and change remaining in the third quarter. And, by the way, they haven't been shut out. They've only been shut out once in the history of this franchise at home, and that was October 4th of 1981. And there's still a long way to go. But we've got 5 minutes left here, and it's 13-0.
That's Fred Biletnikoff there talking to Coach Shell. He coaches the wide receivers.
Tell you what, if you took the coaching staff of the Raiders and take all the guys that are in the Hall of Fame and got them in their prime, they'd probably be playing a lot better than the group that's on the field right now.
Their defense can't play much better than their prime right now. They're doing a good job.
Well, the Chargers are playing into their hands on first down. It's been 14 run calls and only one pass. They've got to throw more on first down.
On second down, up the middle, and finally getting a little bit room to run is LaDainian Tomlinson, and he has not had much since the second quarter. Remember, he had 100 yards in the first half.
Well, they plugged up the point of attack, and with his ability, he's even more of a threat when he cuts back.
Still going to be a third down.
Start to the left. Look at it. It's all plugged up. Bang. Here he comes back. Backside blocking. Every bit as important as onside blocking for offensive linemen.
He's only averaging 2 yards a carry in the second half. 17 yards on 8 carries. Now he's got a third down and short right here. Third and one. And he'll get it again. And he's got the first down. Needs to get out to the 22-yard line. Got to almost the 23. Kirk Morrison, the middle linebacker, made the stop.
All right, like I said right now, Brad, it's to this point, a first down here. They've ran the ball 14 times, only one pass. That's going to allow the Raiders to jam the box.
Phillip Rivers has not had to throw much. And there's what they've done on first down play selection tonight. And the one pass was the swing pass to LaDainian Tomlinson, and he made a sensational catch on that one.
They're in that unbalanced line now to the left, Ron. See him loaded up there?
Michael Turner this time.
Ooh, great block. Great block.
You know, Turner's a good-looking back. He's a load. He's 237, 238 pounds.
Lorenzo Neal, the fullback. Kicks out 41, the left side of
there
the
you
street.
See it right there, coach. As you're talking about Shane Olivier, the right 41. Tackle over at that
bang.
Tight end.
Look
position.
At that block.
That's that heavy hello. Front again. That's that heavy old line.
You like that stuff.
Elephant. Yeah. Shane Olivier, nice job. Versatile player. Signed to a new contract as well.
Second down and 4 now. The football at the 24-yard line. Final 2:45 of the third quarter. Chargers with a lead in the ball. And this time, the Raiders do a good job of stopping the run. Eric Burgess, who led the team and the NFL in sacks last year. He became the first Raider ever to lead the NFL in sacks. He came over, really hadn't had that much work in Philadelphia as far as sacking the quarterback, and he was quite a find.
Yes, he was. You know, he thinks, and he was very sincere in talking to us, Ron, that we're going to be a better defense, he said, this year. We have limited our packages, and we better understand them, and I think we can play a lot better. He's proving that statement true here in the second half.
And he also plays the run. He led the league in sacks, but he's also a very good run defender. That's sometimes overlooked.
Oops. Everybody moving, including the left side of the Charger line, it appeared, but we'll wait and see.
I always love this thing. Everyone points the other way.
Yeah, they're all pleading their case. There's only one guy that matters, and that's a guy with a white hat down there. And Bill Levy will come out of that big pile.
False start. Number 7, the offense. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Shane Olivier.
You said something nice about him. He goes off.
There you go. Oh, yeah, he jumped.
See, he's over tight end on the left side right now. But Gates is over at the right tackle position, up on the line of scrimmage. The wide receivers off the line of scrimmage. They're in their elephant formation.
You would think this was going to definitely change the play. Could have been a rundown. Now it's third and 8.
Well, this is the situation Cam Cameron, the offensive coordinator, has tried to keep Phillip Rivers out of, the known passing situation where the defense can now mix it up, and also the defensive line put their hand in the ground, kick back, lower that butt, and come after the QB.
I'm not sure I'd ever take Antonio Gates out of the lineup, but they did, and there's 3 wideouts, and they're going to keep it on the ground anyway. And it's Turner, and he's stopped again. So the Oakland defense is doing its job. It's been out there a lot. They've done yeoman's work in the third quarter. They're going to force another punt here. Now it's up to the offense to get the job done.
Again, yeah, that young Thomas Howard, a rookie there, one of the 2 rookies starting in that defense, making a real nice play.
The fastest linebacker at the combine. That guy ran under 4.4. He's 6'3", 240 pounds. It's crazy.
Kind of had my speed.
Yeah.
Yeah, hey, come on.
Yours was in the, yours was in the 20. His was in the 20, not the 40. Here's a kick.
Look at the punch.
Carr. On the 21. Trying to reverse his field, and he's going to lose the ball.
No, he's down.
No, he's not.
Chargers say they have it. Still no indication from the officials. Now they say he's down.
Good call, coach. Yeah. Your eyes are better than mine.
Good guess. No, I thought he was down. I thought he was down. But those punts are up in the air forever. I don't know what the hang time, but they've got to be 5-1 and 5-2 hang time.
You would think we're in
down,
Denver
so
right
he's
now.
Down. Yeah. Imagine what these guys will do in Denver. Oh. To punt it out of the end zone. That'd be up then to bleachers.
And you see he was down before the ball came out. Chris Carr, though, did fumble 5 times on kick returns. That's the second most of anybody in the league last year. So he has some trouble in that area.
I wonder if they're taking Courtney Anderson out of the ballgame. The tight end's dropped three passes. No, he's still in there. Don't throw to him.
Charger sneaking up, showing blitz. Brooks, down he goes again.
Rid of it.
Sean Merriman is going to be the player of the year again, I think, on defense if he keeps playing like this. Sixth sack of the night by the Chargers.
Brooks has got to get rid of the football. Five-step drop. You'll see Anderson is released here, but once again, get rid of the football. The body is around. That back foot hits. Coach, I can hear it in my dreams at night. When you start, that back foot hits. You got to process information. Get the ball out of your hand.
And Lamont Jordan has got to take up the slack. When that linebacker comes, especially this guy, you've got to go up and attack him on the line of scrimmage. Merriman with a full steam like that, head of steam, he knocks him right in the quarterback.
Sean Merriman has three sacks
tonight.
That's
a hold.
84.
This one's going to be Castillo, and he's got two, but the penalty marker is down.
Yeah, I think the rookie McQuiston is going to be called for holding.
Holding, number 79 offense. Penalties declined, third down.
Irv Eatman coaches the offensive line along with Jack Slater for the Raiders right now. I bet they're pulling their hair out.
So that's a sack, guys, with a declined penalty. That's seven tonight.
You see it right there, and it's just obvious. I mean, Castillo comes inside, and McQuiston just had to pull him down. He got beat from Jump Street as soon as that ball was snapped.
Wow.
This is the end
of the third quarter. And again, you hear the boos resonating around the Coliseum. Can the Raiders do anything about it? San Diego leads 13-0.
An all-new contender. Tomorrow, 10 p.m. Eastern on ESPN.
Is it permissible to hide Miller Lite in the fridge?
Sure, I like to stash one in the butter door.
I like to hide mine in the crack of a turkey.
Guys, this is an outrage. When it comes to beer, sharing is caring.
For great taste, there's no debate. Miller Lite.
What exactly does this class teach?
How to be a man.
It is time to kill or be killed.
His lessons are tough.
Spread out!
His methods are ruthless.
We know you broke him.
And know these guys, they're not cops.
But his students...
I really like your hair.
Long answer! Who's next?
...are not going to take it anymore. From the director of Old School, Billy Bob Thornton, John Heder, with Ben Stiller.
And the knee?
Oh, damn.
A School for Scoundrels, rated PG-13.
Time for something new from eBay.
eBay Express is the new place to find new items you can buy right away. From new...
ebayexpress.com.
Beautiful scene on a beautiful night for football. It just hasn't been pretty for the Raiders so far as we head into the fourth quarter and the final quarter of our NFL kickoff weekend of the final quarter of our ESPN Monday night doubleheader. There's been Super Bowls in there, but that guy has been there before, and the look on his face tells the whole story. Third down and 20. Longest third down situation of the night, and the Raiders have been in a bunch of them. Brooks fires an incomplete in the vicinity of Randy Moss. Sean Merriman's had a whale of a night with three sacks already tonight. We mentioned he was the defensive rookie of the year, consensus defensive rookie of the year, went to the Pro Bowl, and he says he thinks he can get better. And if he gets much better and he's playing tonight, I wouldn't want to be trying to block him.
You have to outlaw him. You have to outlaw him. This, he looks like Lawrence Taylor.
Yeah, and he's a student of the game. He talked to us about this the video setup he has at home, you know, with the big TV. And, you know, he studies guys like Lawrence Taylor. He studied Derek Thomas. I mean, this is the kind of guy that respects the tradition of the game and tries to improve himself.
Parker is going to clear everybody out of the way and let it roll wisely, although it does get a good bounce down to the 42-yard line. Still Good field position for the Chargers, up 13-0. And we get a 30 at 30. Let's check back in with Carl Ravage. Carl?
Hot Rod baseball stuff. Tigers off, but they're getting snuck up on. Michael Kadire at a home run at four RBIs. Torrey Hunter goes deep. They're a game and a half behind the Tigers, and they lead the White Sox by a game and a half in the wild card to the Twins. White Sox just beat the Angels. Deion Branch, no longer a Patriot. He's a Seahawk now. The Pats get Seattle's number one pick in the 07 draft. You'll get ESPN alerts all the time. SportsCenter after the fourth quarter.
All right, Carl, first down for Phillip Rivers. On play action throws, let Ladainian Tomlinson on the runs, got it. And he's out of bounds near midfield, a pickup of about eight. Chargers did a nice job just on field position there. They had it down to their own seven. Now they got it back at a 42.
Brad, you're absolutely right. The hidden yards in a game, sometimes they're not talked about. The change of field position on the exchange of punts and the good defense by the San Diego Chargers, which kept moving the Raiders backwards.
It's the first time they've been outside their own 20.
10 minutes difference, basically, in time of possession as we're here in the fourth quarter. And a disgruntled offense for the Oakland Raiders has done very little. Second down and three, ball at the 49. Tomlinson.
It's coming. They're gonna run that reverse.
They used it once. They fumbled the exchange once. Tomlinson got about a yard to midfield.
Well, Marty's watching it. He's watching that backside. He's lulling them to sleep. They're going to run that dive, And all of a sudden, you're going to see Rivers keep that ball and hand it off to the wide receiver coming around. And it's been Eric Parker. So I wouldn't be surprised. Eventually, we're going to see that reverse.
That's Cam Cameron, the offensive coordinator for the Chargers.
He's done a great job with his offense over there since taking over there with Marty.
Third down and two. McCardell. In motion, Tomlinson goes down. That's close. I think he's got it.
Yeah, I think he made it too.
Right on our yellow line for the first down mark. They might have to take a look at this. We haven't had a measurement all night.
We're talking about Cam Cameron, Ron. Two consecutive years of over 400 points. That hadn't happened with the Charger organization since 80 and 81. Don Coryell offense,
right.
You know, with the great football team they had at that. So he's doing an outstanding job. He'll be a head coach in the National Football League within the next couple of years.
Well, if you're talking about him like that, I'm sure that other people are going to look at him.
I first saw him when he was a quarterback coach at the University of Michigan, coaching all those good guys.
He's been a head coach in college, just
Indiana.
Not in the pros yet. First down at the 48. Toss. Tomlinson. Swarmed under, no gain. Kirk Morrison, the middle linebacker. They like Morrison a lot. Had a good season last year, and he's just getting better.
You know, the one thing I'm beginning to see is this Raider defense commit eight and even nine to the box as Andrew Walters on the sideline warming up. He is the backup quarterback. But what that's leaving is Asamoah and Fabian Washington man-to-man on the outside, coach, and bump and run. And our old friend Sid Gilman used to always say, don't let him play a man-to-man on the outside, bump and run. Take your shot deep.
Second down and 10. Are they going to have the end around? They keep working it, but they keep giving it to Ladainian. And he's down to the 46, inside the 46, a pickup of three. Now the clock is becoming a huge factor for the Raiders now, too. We're under 12 minutes. They trail by two touchdowns. They could just get one big play. They haven't been able to get a turnover.
They haven't tried one big play downfield.
No.
They really haven't gone downfield with football.
One Chargers haven't
turned it over yet either. The Raiders were terrible in that capacity last year in the turnover ratio. And they only had five interceptions all year. And Rivers isn't throwing it enough to give them a chance to get an interception and turn
it over. But I'll tell you, early in the year, their offense, we were fortunate to beat them here on a Sunday night, second game of the season here. They were tough.
San Diego takes a timeout. With 11:28 remaining in the ballgame, they're in front 13-0.
So, boss, what keeps you up at night? Maybe you've been tasked with coming up with the next best thing since sliced bread. But look at the guy who invented sliced bread. He didn't invent bread. He didn't invent slicing. He just applied new technology to an age-old problem. Now, who's gonna help you do that?
This is Gary Poole, a genial guy from Trenton, New Jersey. Gary's been married for almost 10 years, but until a recent trip to McDonald's, didn't know it. Gary had fresh brewed premium roast coffee with his McGriddles, and it was like he was seeing her for the very first time.
He had no idea we were married.
Gary thought she was cute, so it was okay.
It's like we're newlyweds all over again.
Start your morning with richer, bolder premium roast coffee and add a warm, tasty McGriddles. Wake up and smell your life.
I hope there aren't any other wives.
Ergonomic desk chairs? I watched their back. $650. Office pet?
/ watchdog.
$100. Laptops instead of desktops?
Big ideas don't only come between 9 and 5.
$999 each. Running your business your way. No questions asked.
Nice.
Priceless. Nice. Oh. Use your MasterCard business card for a chance to win $50,000 for your business.
Special. Walmart. Always low prices, always. The Guardian, starring Kevin Costner and Ashton Kutcher. Sneak preview this Saturday, September 16th. And NFL.com. Log on and watch all the highlights from every NFL game this season. It's all on NFL.com.
Beautiful shot above McAfee Coliseum in Oakland. Our aerial coverage being brought to you by Goodyear. It is a perfect night for football. Weather-wise, just not a perfect night for the Raiders so far. They trail 13-0, and they're running out of time. Third and 7 for Phillip Rivers and the Chargers. Rivers going to go deep. Got a man out there and got him in stride inside the 10-yard line to Eric Parker, and a perfect throw.
Perfect, perfect throw. Good pass protection, though he got rid of the ball in rhythm.
And Warren Sapp was in his face. And you've got to look down the gun barrel in the National Football League, and you will see Phillip Rivers do that. Play action to Turner. Look at him set. Deliver the football under adverse conditions. Puts the ball on the money. Eric double Parker, move.
Double move. Great call.
Can't throw it any better than that, Joss.
And he put some velocity on it to beat the safety coming over the top. If you'd have laid it out there, the safety would have knocked him out.
38-yard pickup, first and goal, Chargers at the Raiders 7. Now it's back to number 21, and he's inside the 5 to the 4. Parker, good look at him. He had 57 catches last year, career highs, 57 catches, 725 yards, and he only started 9 games. So he's a pretty good one in his fifth year out of Tennessee.
You know, Brad, a moment ago, the coach and I were talking during that break. You can't hide your quarterback, and it appeared to me they were trying to hide Phillip Rivers, and eventually you're going to have to ask him to make a play. Well, they asked him to make a play, and he made it. So give him more opportunities.
He made it with authority, didn't he?
Yes, he did. Nice job.
Second down and goal. 129 yards on the ground for LaDainian Tomlinson, including a touchdown tonight. Will he get it again? Nope. Now it's Rivers rolling and throwing and touchdown, and it's Antonio Gates. So they asked him to make a play twice on that series, and he's got his first touchdown pass as a starter.
It's right tight end position. A little fire pass coming out of the backfield there. Quarterback rolling to the play. There he is. Bang. One-on-one coverage on the safety, Derek Gibson.
So again, Antonio Gates in the red zone is money.
Yes, he is. You get running the ball like they've been running the ball on every down, and then you fake that thing coming off tackle. That is tough on the strong safety.
Well, you bring Gibson, who really is a run defender. Now he's stuck matching up against Gates, and it's a mismatch. Yeah. Gates is going to win that 99% of the time.
Yeah. And he didn't have far to go.
Antonio Gates. The All-Pro and Phillip Rivers, one happy young quarterback. It is 20-0 San Diego.
Tonight on SportsCenter, full highlights and analysis from Monday Night Football's first ever doubleheader. Plus the top 10 plays from the NFL's Week 1. SportsCenter immediately following Monday Night Football.
From the fields of glory where Saturday afternoon legends are born, it's time for college football. And now you can bring that passion home with Fathead. Easy to put up, easy to move. Fathead will stick with you all season long. But you can't buy them in stores. There's only one place to get them. Fathead.com. Officially licensed by the Collegiate Licensing Company, NASCAR, the NBA, the NFL, and Players Inc. Find all your favorite players and teams. Call or go to Fathead.com and show them your Fathead.
Hey.
You want to see something cool?
Now you can hang out with an NFL quarterback with Fathead, a larger-than-life wall graphic. Fathead brings NFL action right into your home or office.
Fathead is huge. The coolest thing is, put it on the wall. You don't like it there, peel it off, put it on another wall.
Visit Fathead.com for your officially licensed Fathead teams and players.
Call and get a fat head.
Fathead is for true NFL fanatics only.
Take those posters off the wall and put on Fathead.
Hello, people in TV land, get a Fathead.
He's got nothing but open field ahead
of him.
He's
been all Sunday watching games on the tube.
Spent all Sunday watching games on the tube.
But you missed 85 and there was nothing you could do.
Nothing for you to do.
So here's a suggestion from a real good friend. You can check out the games on the NFLN.
NFL Replay. The four best games from Sunday, replayed on NFL Network Tuesday and Wednesday nights.
NFL Replay. On the NFL Network.
Chargers pitching a shutout against their arch rivals from here in Oakland. 20-0 now, the Chargers in front. And look at the smile on Phillip Rivers' face. His first career start, and as Jaws said, they didn't ask him to do much. Finally, he threw a laser to Eugene Parker for 38 yards. That set him up first and goal. They got it down to the four, and he threw to his all-pro tight end for the touchdown. 58-yard drive and eight plays. Carr from the five on the kick return. Trying to cut it to the near side. Gets what he can and gets out to about the 23, maybe the 24-yard line.
Phillip Rivers makes a great play to set up the touchdown pass to Antonio Gates. The defense will play the situation. As you see right there, Fabian Washington plays the 39 and jumps it out. But it was a double move. So now you see the terrific throw right there. But the key is watch Phillip Rivers. And the players, they look at the tape tomorrow, are going to love this. Looking down the gun barrel. That's Warren Sapp coming after you. He hung out of the ball to the last possible second. He says, hey, Warren, I got it off, buddy.
We had something to say to Warren, too.
Yeah, he'll tone that down quick enough.
Andrew Walter is in at quarterback for the Raiders. A third-round draft choice from a year ago, and back to throw. The youngster out of Arizona State throws and caught. Nope, broken up. Ronald Curry took one in the chops.
So did the quarterback. Luis Castillo hit him right in the back.
Aaron Brooks leads the ball game. Guys, get a load of this one as we get another look at the hits.
Nice hit by
Drayton Florence.
Drayton Florence really popped him.
Aaron Brooks left the game with more sacks than completions. That's not a good sign.
No.
Seven sacks, six completed passes.
If you were a backup quarterback, would you want to go in?
I think Walter was saying, you know, Aaron's playing pretty good, coach. I think I'll leave him in there.
He really got hit. He really got hit on that last one.
Second and 10. Walter again to throw. Find himself some time. Lofts it, incomplete. Andrew Walter, guys, out of Arizona State, they thought pretty highly of him, obviously making a third-round draft choice. Now, Matt Leinart was around this year when the Raiders drafted, and I think basically they said this guy's going to be our future because they didn't make any draft pick for a quarterback.
You know, I watched him in the preseason tapes. I liked what I saw. I think good delivery. He looked like he knew what he was doing. Of course, you've got to give a quarterback protection to really do what you can do. But mechanically and physically, he looked good to me.
Well, but I don't think that the Raiders right now are going to say, hey, we're going to go with the young quarterback project. They brought in Brooks where they thought they were getting a veteran guy where they could be competitive. Obviously, this could change the whole plan for the season if they decide to go with Walter or even Marcus Kouyaté-Sokou, the number three quarterback.
Fly down, delay game.
Offense, five-yard penalty, third down.
So it's going to make another one of those third down and long situations for them. Third down and 15. How many times have they been in that situation? Six times tonight. Dick, you were telling me off the air. How many per games a coach expect to run into third down and longs?
That long? About one to two, or maybe three, third and 10 pluses.
But not six.
Not six.
Walter with heat coming. And down he goes again.
That's more than heat.
Sean Phillips and Sean Merriman, the Sean Show. Wow. It is a sack lunch tonight for the Charger defense.
I mean, boy, they're making some bonus money tonight, I'll tell you that.
Coming around.
But watch all the plays, Coach. There's seven-step drop. They're running routes at 18 to 20 yards. By the time Walter's back foot was planting, he had no shot to get rid of the ball.
You see, they were third and 10, and they wanted to go deep rather than throw it in front of the coverage and try to run for the first down. But it doesn't matter what they can do. So far, they haven't done anything very well.
This guy's been the only bright spot. That's pretty bad when you're talking about a punter being your bright spot. Parker will field it at the 35. Eric Parker, who made that big catch on the last drive, gets across the 40, got planted at about the 42-yard line. Well, they came out in full force. It was a sellout crowd, and some of them are saying, you know what, I'm going home. As their team is down 20 to nothing with 8:48 remaining.
Ineligible man downfield, number 42 of the kicking team. 5-yard penalty will be added on to the end of the run. First down.
So that'll give the Chargers even better field position. 8:48 remaining in the ball game. Chargers in control over the Oakland Raiders.
This offers incomparable picture quality.
So why does it cost so much?
It's HD TV, sir. Top of the line.
No, I mean, why does it cost more here?
Yeah, Walmart has the same one for way less.
We have a high-def buyers club where you can earn points towards your choice of reward. If you spend $50,000, there's a digital meat smoker.
The same brand name HD TVs as other stores for way less. Get smart before you buy at walmart.com/HDTV.
23 flavors in every Dr. Pepper add up to so much taste. 23 is always on the tip of your tongue.
At the end of the 23rd quarter, it's all tied up 23-23.
We'll be back after a brief 23-second timeout.
Thanks, guys. Dr. Pepper and ESPN are giving you a chance to throw for $1 million. Go to ESPN.com, keyword pepper to enter. Because with 23 flavors in every Dr. Pepper, there's always more to it.
Why don't we have a wireless network like the Kumar Swamis?
Hello, neighbor.
Show-offs. Because ours is more exciting. Maybe it'll work, maybe it won't. Which messages will I get? It's like a fun little surprise.
That last time wasn't.
Grandma's forgiven us now. Haven't you, Graham? She will.
Doesn't your family deserve America's most reliable wireless network? Now, buy the latest VCast Samsung phone with a navigation system. Get the second one free. Verizon Wireless. It's the network.
Saturday Night Football on ABC. Nebraska versus USC this Saturday at 8.
San Diego leads Oakland 20 to nothing. Randy Moss has been basically a non-factor tonight. Had three catches really on one drive, and that was about it. SportsCenter will follow us as we wrap up the first big weekend of NFL football with the first ever doubleheader in the history of the game. Earlier tonight, the Vikings beat the Redskins, and now the Chargers on the road, like Minnesota, doing the same to the Raiders. There's some guys that had superb games. Sean Phillips, Sean Merriman, and that whole group on the defensive side of the football for San Diego has really played well.
Marty has stated that he thinks this front seven is as good as there is in the National Football League. And boy, tonight, I don't know if this is a true test, but they look awfully good.
Second down and 8, just shaded on the Chargers side of midfield. Gates in motion. Tomlinson can only add to, it's Michael Turner, I beg your pardon.
You know, Peter Strait stayed with that running play. They had a nice stretch going. The wing came over there and the tight end of movement. They had a nice block to the outside, and he cut it back. If he stayed with that a little bit more, a little more patient, he probably would have popped that thing.
Yeah, press that hole a little bit.
Yeah.
But Adanian Tomlinson does check back in after Turner got that carry. Adanian's over his average against the Raiders. He loves playing the Raiders as much as Marty Schottenheimer likes beating the Raiders.
Yeah, Marty was talking to Wade Phillips, the defensive coordinator, on the sideline, and probably saying, hey, if you have to send the defense out there, you want to start putting some backups in there.
Quick opener. Tomlinson's going to go down, though, before he can get the first down. Got a yard or two. Tommy Kelly made another stop. Well, Phillip Rivers making his first start in his third year out of North Carolina State, and he's done some nice things. Antonio Gates there. Then he went deep, and Parker caught it beautifully in stride. That set up a first and goal, and then he found his all-pro tight end, Antonio Gates, in just a little bit of excitement.
You know, Marty Schottenheimer is managing Phillip Rivers, much like Bill Cowher managed Ben Roethlisberger. Give him 20 to 22 passes a game. Don't ask him to win the game by throwing 40 times. And with a young quarterback, that's the way to do it.
Short kick this time. Fair catch taken at about the 18-yard line. So the Raiders are running out of time. 8:40 to play. They need some big plays, and they need them in a hurry.
SportsCenter, full highlights and analysis from Monday Night Football's first ever doubleheader, plus the top 10 plays from the NFL's Week 1. SportsCenter immediately following Monday Night Football.
The all-new Acura RDX with super handling all-wheel drive. Praised by man and machine, the all-new Acura RDX.
You're always telling your friends about DirecTV, so why not get paid for it? Help us spread the word, and we'll give you $100. Your friends not only get DirecTV's top-ranking service, they can get a free DirecTV Plus DVR and a free portable DVD player. And you get a $100 credit on your DirecTV bill. Got a lot of friends? No problem. There's no limit on how many referrals you can make. And for each friend you refer, you get a chance to win 2 round-trip tickets to Super Bowl 41 in the Refer a Friend Sweepstakes.
Now your business can get up to 5% cash back on everything you buy.
Cash back on EKG machines.
Cash back on drywall.
On engines.
On computers.
Just apply for the Platinum Business Cash Rebate Card from American Express. There's no annual fee and no limit to how much you can earn.
$640 back. Nice.
So call 1-800-NOW-OPEN today and start getting up to 5% cash back.
Cash back that goes right back into my pocket.
Ryan Bingham's in there.
6:40 remaining in the ballgame. San Diego. Andrew Walter back to throw. Harassed in the pocket again. Look out, young guy. And penalty marker down at the 20-yard line. Sean Phillips tracked him down from behind. He actually got a yard, but again, a flag on the play. The Raiders' deepest penetration into San Diego territory has been the San Diego 33-yard line.
Holding, number 76 offense. Half the distance to the goal, repeat first down.
Robert Gallery in his first start at left tackle is having a heck of a time. And his first start over in what is his regular spot, or at least it was at Iowa. In his third year, the former number one draft choice, number two overall pick. Of course, he's playing against a front seven that has played like the Purple People Eaters or a Steel Curtain or something tonight, or the Fearsome Foursome.
Well, you got to give some credit to Wade Phillips, a defensive coordinator. Out of this 3-4 defense, he does a lot of things. He really confuses the block.
Fumble. Jordan dropped it. I think he got, no, maybe he didn't get back on top of it. Scramble for the football. Apparently, the Raiders are going to keep it.
Yeah, you make the call.
Yeah, you make the call. They muffed the draw handoff. Yeah. The backup quarterback probably hadn't run with that first unit running back in a while on practice field, which happens. Turnover.
And the Chargers have got it.
Wow, you wonder what you write down on your notebook when you see a play like that.
Fumble. Yeah. And not a good one.
The first turnover of the game, and it's not something the Raiders needed. That's for sure.
When Andrew Walter put the ball up high on Lamont Jordan's chest and bounced it off his pads. And coach, as you said, you know, you got a backup quarterback in there who probably hasn't repped a whole lot with the first unit, and this is what's going to happen.
It's early in the season, guys, but this is not a good sign for the Oakland Raiders.
It's been an awful performance. I mean, you can't cut it any other way. They've been dreadful.
Unbalanced left again here. Oakland. They must have something off it.
They give it to the fullback. Give a little sugar to Lorenzo Neal, the Pro Bowl fullback, and he got 4 yards.
He didn't get to carry it very often. Last year, 29 times the whole season. He's ahead of his average right now. Just to keep him smiling.
That's right. That's what I say. You got to give him a little love, give him a little sugar, those fullbacks.
Yeah. His neck's getting shorter.
It's getting shorter all the time.
Boy, he made the Pro Bowl last year, and did he ever deserve it?
He's a terrific guy. Yeah. Just a guy you can talk to all day long. He has a passion for the game, an enthusiasm to go out and block. And, you know, that's what you have to play that fullback position. It's kind of the old school kind of player.
Yeah, there are not many of them coming out of college anymore. These are all in those spread formations and shotguns and that. There's just not many of them around.
Now the give off the left side is to Turner. And Turner got it down inside the two, maybe to the one. Kirk Morrison made the stop as clock will wind its way under the five-minute mark. And the Chargers look like they're going to add points to this and add insult to injury against the hated Raiders. 194 rushing yards to the 46 for Oakland.
It looks like Marty Ball is back.
At least in Oakland.
At least in Oakland. Marty with another win over the hated Raiders in his mind.
Turner in there with Neal. Third down and goal. Turner, touchdown. Stills got his feet moving. Ran over Robert Thomas, and now the Chargers celebration can really begin. And the trip back to Southern California. That bull thing that they're doing is for Steve Foley, their teammate.
Off tackle, kick out block again. See, we just complimented Lorenzo Neal, number 41, and he comes back and does a real nice job of kicking out. They doubled down, kicked out. He and actually hear him that too on his own.
Penalty markers all over the field. And I think it's going to be for the bull stomp that was going on with the teammates. Again, that is for Steve Foley, who's in the hospital. We talked about the gunshot wounds, and that's one of the things they were going to do special for him tonight. And it really doesn't matter in this case.
Taunting, number 33 of the offense. The penalty will be enforced 15 yards on the kickoff.
And here's another look as the guys get together, Turner and Neal and Gates, and they've all got the same thing going on for their teammate who's not here, and it cost him a penalty, but it really doesn't matter with 4.5 to go in a game that's about to be 27-0, and it is. So they'll tack that penalty on the kickoff. And we're down to 4.5 minutes to play. Hopefully next week the Steelers and the Jaguars will give us something a little bit better than what we're seeing right now. ESPN's Monday Night Football showcases defending Super Bowl champions. They'll take on Byron Leftwich, who looked good yesterday as he led the Jaguars to a win over the Cowboys. Action starts 8:30 Eastern, 5:30 Pacific. It can also be experienced in high definition on ESPN HD. Steelers and the Jags. Mike and Tony and Joe will have all of that for you next week on Monday Night Football. Well, fellas, the first weekend rolls around, and you don't very often, Dick, see as many visiting teams win football games as we saw this first weekend.
I know it. You know, there have been years when the visiting team has won more, but not many.
Yeah.
Not many.
This is going to be the what? Ninth visiting team that's going to win this weekend, or is it 10?
Brad, did you see those the yardage numbers? It was absolutely incredible. It looked like the Raiders had 46 total yards.
Oh.
That has to be some sort of record for the Oakland Raiders, a team that is rich in tradition. They used to get 46 yards on one pass play on a regular basis.
And as Andrew Walter came in, I'm sure he wanted to play, but he wanted to come in a situation like this.
Can't blame the quarterback.
But they will. You know that, Coach. A quarterback is always going to get too much credit when things go well and too much blame when things go poorly. And certainly things have gone very poorly for the Raiders here this evening.
Chargers had 46 sacks last year, and they've got a whole bunch already tonight. Here's the kick. Chris Carr will get some good field position and flags down. Maybe it won't matter. It's an illegal block. It'll go the other way, and that's just one more thing that the Raiders will continue to have to work on. We talked about them leading the league
during
in penalties.
The return, holding, number 40, receiving team. 10-yard penalty spot of the foul. First down, Oakland.
Art, there'll be better days. At least I hope so for you. Let's check in with Bonnie.
Well, Sean Merriman has a lot to do with the fact that the Raiders haven't been able to put any points on the board today, Brad. Talked about him putting that film room in his house, and he's been boxing with his uncle, Henry Buchanan, who's a pro, 150-pound lightweight. He's 15-0, and Merriman was saying, you know, it is 60 minutes of football, but in reality, you're doing 20 seconds worth of a play and then resting for 30, whereas a round of boxing is 3 minutes of straight work one-on-one with a guy, and it's really helped build his endurance.
I don't think I'd want to do any Muay Thai with Sean Merriman because you get elbows and knees and everything involved. It's not just punching. That guy's done it all tonight.
Yes, he has.
Wow.
Unbelievable football
He might
player.
Be the next very great player. We talked about, you know, you talked about it earlier, Jaws. He's looked at films of LT and Derek Thomas and a lot of guys like that. He came out with a statement not that long ago and talked about Junior Seau. And he said he got taken a little bit out of context because he said, I'm going to be better than Junior Seau. Well, he said to us yesterday, he says, I meant no disrespect. I love the game. Junior went to 12 Pro Bowls. I've only been playing a year. I didn't mean it the way it sounded. All I said was, I think because of my physical skills, if I keep working and I keep doing different things and I keep studying the greats like Junior Seau, someday maybe I can be as good or better than him. So I love the way that he explained that to us because, you know, when the story first came out, it kind of looked like he was saying, hey, man, I'm going to be better than Junior.
Yeah, and there's another dimension to this guy, a pass rush dimension.
Right.
You know, and that's, I mean, he's a defensive end and a linebacker, and, I mean, a vicious pass rusher.
And 268 pounds, and his body fat's down from what was a year ago because of what Bonnie showed us with those workouts. I mean, it's just frightening to think of the size of that guy and the speed he's got and that he can play so well in just his second year.
And he's got that new tattoo on his neck that says, finish strong.
Justin Fargas makes a nice run.
Justin Fargas all the way down inside the 35-yard line. Shows a little bit of spark.
That's right. Yeah, now they're going to start running the football. We thought that was going to be the plan. They were going to go back to the Raider tradition of that smash-mouth style of football, but they certainly waited far too long to get the running game going or commit themselves to the running game.
Randy Moss, you know, is not going to be happy about his game tonight. Fewest offensive yards in a game in Raider history. Tonight they've got 97. And that is their first down that Vargas just got him since the 13-minute mark remaining in the third quarter. Yikes.
They got two guys in motion.
And now they call a timeout.
Boy, back out open. That's their first charge.
Had the flanker back, Johnny Morant, went in motion, as did the running back. And the quarterback was kicking the heel to get the running back to come over to block. And the wide receiver is going in motion same time. I think they're a little bit
confused. You know, you have Rashard Lee in the backfield, number 42. He has not seen a lot of snaps or probably did not see many reps at practice this week. So there certainly was a breakdown of communication. Now Randy's communicating.
Don't forget SportsCenter is coming up after the game. Scott Van Pelt, Neil Everett. They'll have post-game on the Charger-Raider game, the Vikings-Redskins breakdown. NFL top plays of week one. I always love that. I doubt that Trent Green is still awake this late at night, but Trent, we hope you get better quickly, too. I know Tony Gonzalez called you today, Coach, and said, how's Trent doing? I can't get a hold of him.
I said, I haven't talked to Trent. I've tried to. My wife, Carol, talked to Julie Green and got a good report.
That's good.
He might miss a game or two, but he's doing okay.
Tip pass incomplete with 2:15 to go. And the Raiders have never had three straight losing seasons ever. They've had three, and now they maybe will be shut out at home for only the second time in history. Denver did it to them in 1981.
I've never seen them look like this in this Coliseum. Never.
Art in here is a war.
Yeah. I mean, Art has
had to come from behind. He got a lot of work to do between now and next Sunday.
That's what I was going to get at, Dick, if I can, after this play. Here's a little quick draw. The farthest. What do you do, Dick, now that you're Art Shell? You go, okay, now what do we do?
Well, first off, you don't panic.
Yeah.
You know, and you're right away, go into your program for handling adversity.
This early in the season?
After the first game, you've got to have a plan for that.
Week two?
We'll talk more about it when we come back. We're at the two-minute warning. 27-0 San Diego.
Time for something new from eBay.
eBay Express is the new place to find new items you can buy right away. From new plasma TVs to new power drills, eBay Express, where you'll always find it new.
Get it new, buy it now. eBayExpress.com.
Now is the time to prove to yourselves and prove to everyone out there
you are somebody.
This Friday,
believe in yourself. That's all you need.
Gridiron Gang, rated PG-13.
Coach, you're a fan of the Coors Light Frost Brew Liner, right?
Darn right.
Wouldn't you say it locks in that Frost Brew taste?
I can say it with confidence.
Coach, would you say the Frost Brew Liner rocks?
I think that's probably as well as I can state it. I don't know.
Every Coors Light can is a specially designed liner to lock in that refreshing Frost Brew taste.
Coach, I started lifting again.
Can you tell?
I don't see any changes that would be visible, you know.
No more secrets. Where are we going for our honeymoon?
A romantic island in the south.
Jamaica?
Credit card miles are blacked out. A little more south.
Antigua?
Blacked out further south.
Aruba?
Getting warmer.
Isn't this great? Did you notice? No bugs.
We gotta switch to Capital One.
Get Capital One's new no-hassle rewards. Now with no blackout dates, no earn caps, and no miles expiration.
Hey, it's walrus mating season.
What's in your wallet?
The NFL and United Way have been helping to strengthen America's communities for years. Maybe you can give us a hand. Volunteer at unitedway.org.
Or two. All right, SportsCenter follows us. Scott Van Pelt, Neil Everett, guys are standing by, anxiously awaiting us to get done here in the last 2 minutes. Been a long day for everybody. We only had about, 15 hours of NFL coverage on ESPN?
Six.
I love it. I love it.
You can't get enough of it.
I think I did 13.
Walter back. Throws. Got his hand
inside the 10.
Nice touch to Ronald Curry. It's good to see Ron Curry back. He's had Achilles problems the last 2 years. He had a problem with that when he was a quarterback in North Carolina. And his right leg in the last 2 years, his left Achilles has blown up on him. Here he is back, still working.
It was his own coverage, and he just worked in there behind the safety, rolled up in the corner, and did a nice job. And he threw the ball. But he got time
that
to throw the ball.
That was the key, Coach. It was a nice touch. He had to loft that ball over Drayton Florence, who had buzzed out to that flat. But the nice touch on the ball, he was able to get the completion and get inside the 10-yard line for the Rams.
See if the Raiders can avoid that shutout that we were talking about. We're down to 1:15, first and goal. Vargas broke one tackle, danced his way back to the line of scrimmage, and that's about it. Rick Florence made the stop.
He's made a couple good tackles today.
And Carlos Polk made the play, the outside linebacker, number 52. He really forced it to the outside, didn't allow Vargas to really hit that thing flying. He had to get to the sideline, and that's when his friends came to help. Polk and his guys were there.
Marty Schottenheimer will win his 187th regular season game and break the all-time tie in seventh place with Chuck Knox.
Right.
And the winning, most wins for any coach against one team.
Winning his coach coaching today.
Yep.
Marty Schottenheimer. Yeah. I don't think he gets as much credit as due to Marty Schottenheimer.
I agree with you, Coach. I mean, I'm a huge fan of Marty Schottenheimer. And you know, his son Brian now coaching the Jets, the offensive coordinator in New York. And congratulations to Eric Mangini and Brian Schottenheimer and that whole staff. A win.
I was in the office the other day talking to Marty, and I said, Marty, you know, I'm proud of Brian as you are, you know, but starting out as a coordinator in New York, wow, that's a tough spot.
This tells you something right here. The Raiders take a timeout with 15 seconds left. They do not want to be shut out. And
they better kick a field goal.
I think Al Davis signaled timeout.
I don't know. That's what I was getting at. I'm not sure where it was coming from, but Janikowski is stretching his leg at least, because you don't want that hanging over your head, especially in your season opener when you had high hopes and your coach is back for a second tour of duty, as Art Shell is. And so now they're going to have
they'll run an offensive play.
Well, they're going to have to pitch it then to Janikowski, unless he's not going to come out.
Sebastian, he ain't running
anywhere.
He's
lost a few pounds, but he may not be running that distance. Oh, gosh, Art. I you know, I've had my butt beat many, many times in football, and being on that side where Marty is much more fun.
Oh, yeah.
People say, do you miss coaching? I says, well,
all the wins.
Yeah. None of the losses. Third down and goal. Walter steps up in the pocket. He's going to run with it and gets down at about the 9 with 9 seconds remaining. And final timeout taken. So Marty Schottenheimer, who has Raider week and gets his team all geared up for it and came in on the road in a hostile environment with a first-time starting quarterback in Phillip Rivers and the gym rat from Alabama by way of North Carolina State is going to be a happy quarterback tonight. Not huge numbers, but he did a very nice job.
How about his dad?
How about his dad? Yeah, very happy. His dad's here, yeah.
You know, we were talking earlier, and I said in my first start, it was my third year, and I threw 13 passes, and I kind of correlated that to Phillip Rivers. I said, you know, Marty's going to manage his game and not give a lot of opportunities. I didn't think it would ever be 11 throws.
Yeah.
Next week, he'll get up to 17.
That's right.
Hey. Well, when you have LaDainian Tomlinson, there's the duo in the backfield right now.
And he's looking up to him. This kid's going to go fast.
Phillip Rivers, I thought, was outstanding. The kid just reeks of football. He's a fun guy to be around. Players respect him, and tremendous upside.
Walter on fourth down. Throws out complete.
Out of bounds.
Out of bounds with no time remaining if the scoreboard is right. And
Marty's still coaching over there.
He's still coaching, telling his guys to stay off the field. He wasn't sure if it was all zeros up there on the scoreboard, but it is. So he's got another win over the Raiders. He's got his 187th win, moving into seventh place all time, all by himself. LaDainian Tomlinson, huge game. 27-0, San Diego goes to 1-0, Oakland with their loss with Art Schell's return. SportsCenter's next. Right now for Dick Vermeil, Ron Jaworski, Bonnie Bernstein, and the rest of our ESPN crew, Brad Nessler saying goodnight from Oakland. Guys that coached together and coached against each other. One goes home happy and one doesn't. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.
He's no Gary.
There's Gary in there.
I still had a sip left.
Dude, that was amazing.
It was what I had to do.
When someone tried to take your unfinished Bud Light, you must react with quickness. Try to take my Bud Light.
Actually, you can just keep that one.
Again!
How'd you do that?
That was not me. That was my cousin Lou.
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
Again!
I've trained for this my whole life. I cannot fail. I will not fail. Because I am one with a can.
Dr. Pepper has given you a shot at $1 million, but first you gotta get past me. Log on to ESPN.com, keyword Pepper. Beat me at College Pick'em, and you could be passing for the million live at the Big 12 and ACC Championship game Saturday, December 2nd on ABC.
There it is.
Go get it.
Pepper who? I'm the salt. Let's go.
Let me take you through this thing. Look here. 85 on the left side, so everybody on the left really don't even matter.
Who was 35? He jumping at.
Hold up. Pause for the calls.
Madden NFL 2007.
Rated E for everyone.
EA Sports. It's in the game.
ESPN thanks you for watching this presentation of the National Football League.
This is SportsCenter.
You knew LaDainian would do his thing, but would Randy get his? Are the Chargers the real deal, or is Oakland that bad? And with revenge on the mind of one former Redskin quarterback, don't miss a Monday night nail biter in D.C. Plus, from cranking out the hits to a home run record, who kept his streak alive? Find out on SportsCenter.
Right now.
How's
does it. Welcome to SportsCenter alongside Scott Van Pelt. I'm Neil Everett. Reservations for two, please.
Two football games on a Monday night. ESPN proudly welcomes Monday Night Football. Stuart Scott anchoring our coverage from Oakland, which hosted the nightcap. Stuart?
They call it Oaktown, Oakland, California. Couple of Charger fans in the house, but it was mostly the black hole Oakland fans trying to give their team some energy. I don't know if it didn't work or if San Diego is just too good. Stuart Scott hanging out with Coach Mike Ditka. Coach, San Diego was going for their sixth straight win over Oakland. Oakland had the energy of the fans, but that little thing that you're supposed to have didn't quite happen.
Well, the thing called talent, execution, it wasn't there. You know, they can't protect their quarterback. You can't protect the quarterback. You cannot throw the football. They quit trying to run the football early in the game. They got away from that. Once you get away from that, you better be able to protect the quarterback. Quarterback's drops are too deep. I mean, I could go on and on with a list here of what the problems are. But the guy I feel sorry for is Arshel. These guys don't look like they want to play, Stu. They come out here, they're going through the motions.
Well, let's take a look exactly how it went down in Oaktown. Randy Moss and the Raiders, they've lost five straight to the Chargers coming in, whose quarterback, Philip Rivers, making his first NFL start. Lucky for Philip, he had LaDainian Thomas in first quarter. No score. First Charger possession, Rivers. Passed it, LT coming out of the backfield. This is why he's the best running back in the NFL. He can run it, he can catch it. That will lead to a Charger field goal. Next possession, LT, handoff from Rivers. He's down the hole on the right side. 58 yards before he's run out of bounds. Coach, how did that happen so effectively?
Well, what they're doing is they're taking reverse and bringing the back guy around in reverse. Don't ask me, but you watch O'Neal in there. He's the hammer going through that hole. He takes that linebacker on and drives him right out of the hole.
Lorenzo Neal got a big head, but he was banging it. Second quarter, fourth down and goal at the one. LaDainian Tomlinson, touchdown. He's now scored a touchdown in 23 of his last 29 games. Chargers 10-0. Late second, Raiders down 13-0. Aaron Brooks finds Randy Moss, 12 yards in a first down. Same drive, third and 17 for the Chargers, 40. Aaron Brooks takes a deep drop and is sacked by Sean Merriman. Coach, why didn't he get the ball off?
Well, first of all, when it's third and 17, you got to take a deep drop. Their problem is they were in third and 10 plus about eight times in the football game. And by the way, they got nobody, including Robert Gallery, who can block Sean Merriman. Nobody on that football team can block him.
Oakland only had 45 total yards in the first half and third quarter. It was just from the Department of Redundancy.
Oh, watch this.
Sean Merriman coaches ridiculous.
Well, right there, they put a back on him, and they try to block him with a back, and he can't do that either. I mean, this guy is a man among boys, and they're trying. Even when they put the tackle on him, they didn't do a good job.
Merriman had three sacks on his own will. That is Philip Rivers and Eric Parker. Parker ran an up and go, and Warren Sapp needed some therapy or a hug. That set up second and goal. Rivers finds Antonio Gates. First NFL touchdown for Philip Rivers since the 2004 season. Take another look, Coach. How did it unfold?
Well, it's going to be interesting to see what happens when they have to throw the ball. When they have to throw the ball, you know the ball is going to Antonio Gates because he is absolutely, in my opinion, he's the best tight end in football. They didn't even use him tonight because, Stu, they didn't have to use him. They imposed their will on the Oakland Raiders, and that's all you can say.
The Chargers shut out the Raiders for the first time since 1961. 27, nada, nothing. Phillip Rivers, 8 of 11, 108 yards. Not huge numbers, but the big one was the W and a post-game interview with Bonnie Bernstein.
Phillip Rivers, win number one in your career. What is it about this day that's making you smile the most?
It's the win. You know, it was exciting. I've been waiting for this day for a long time. And the win was what's most important, and we got it. It was, the guys played great. It was a real physical game, and got the first one on our belt. It'll make everyone easier, at least to get going.
For as long as you've been waiting, how frustrating was it to have to wait until the fourth quarter to hit Eric Parker and then Antonio Gates for that touchdown pass?
Yeah, you know, I tell you, I've said all along, if I have to hand it off 50 times or throw it 50 times, whatever it takes to win. It was one of those nights where we had control of the game, the defense was playing well, and we didn't need to throw it a whole lot. I hadn't thrown in single digits in my career very often, but we made the throws when we had to, and we were efficient, and we ran the ball well. It was a good team win.
Did I see you trash talking with Warren Sapp? Did I really see that?
No, it wasn't trash talk.
Oh, yes, you were.
I remember growing up, all the stuff with Favre and him and stuff, you know, I just like to have a lot of fun.
How about LT? How much did he allow you to kind of ease yourself into this game?
Yeah, you know, he did a great job. And they put a lot of guys in the box, but we blocked him, and he ran hard, and Michael Turner mixed it up. Lorenzo had some runs, and it was a great physical effort by our bunch. And then when we threw it, we were efficient. And, you know, I know we'll probably throw it more down the road, and that'll be just fine. But we got the first one, you know, out of the way, and we'll be excited to get going next week.
One of potentially many wins for Philip Rivers. Thanks.
Appreciate it.
The first time the Raiders have been shut out at home in 25 years. As I say it, the first time the Chargers have shut out the Raiders since 1961. And Oakland, just 129 yards of total offense the entire game. Coach Ditka, we saw the sacks. Oakland was, they were on the bad side of 9 sacks. Aaron Brooks took the brunt of 7 of them. What was their problem?
Well, it was protection. They got behind. They had deep drops to right. Jaws hit it right on the button. You drop back there 5-7 steps, you're going to have a problem, especially when these guys are coming down around the end. And Merriman is a man among boys, believe me. The tackles couldn't block him, and the backs couldn't block him. They had a big problem with him all the way through the football game. But this team has to reevaluate one thing. They got to reevaluate what is their philosophy for playing offense and defense. Now, defense, I didn't see it too much bad about that. But offense, you've got to figure out, what are we all about? What can we do and what can't we do? And they better figure out what they can do and do it better.
Well, they haven't done it better against their own division. Nope. Since the Raiders went to the Super Bowl against the AFC West, they are 2-17. There was a time that they just used to own San Diego, but it's San Diego, it's the entire AFC West not doing well. Aaron Brooks in this game, his numbers, 6-14, 68 yards. I'm guessing that's not a QB rating of 100. What did you see in him that showed a complete lack of getting it done?
Well, the first thing I saw, you know, what Aaron Brooks does well is when he has time, he throws the ball deep. He can do that, but he didn't have time. They try to throw the ball deep. I just think you got that. You can't hold on to the football that long. You hold, watch it drop. That is 7 steps. Now, the protection was terrible because if it took him 2 seconds to drop 7 steps, they didn't even block for 2 seconds, too. So you can't blame him for everything. The offensive line deserves the most of the blame for what happened out there tonight. Believe me, they were horrible.
Aaron Brooks' quarterback rating in the game, 58. Not great. A big part of that, you mentioned it during the highlight, Sean Merriman, he had 3 sacks by himself. What makes this beast of a man so effective?
He wants it. Here's a guy that goes on the football field. He wants it. He wants to make something happen. Watch him. He's having fun out there. He's put pressure on these guys. And even when they block him, he turns the quarterback into somebody else to get him. Castillo or one of these guys is going to get him. This guy plays the game the way you like to see people play it. Dude, he's having fun. He's like a kid in a candy store. You can't beat that.
He's been in the Pro Bowl. If he keeps having games like this, he's going again after
the
game.
Super Bowl.
To the Super Bowl and the Pro Bowl after the game. Sean Merriman hooked up with Bonnie Bernstein.
The Raiders were hoping this team would have a turnaround, new coach, new quarterback. How did you hold them to under 100 yards?
We came out here ready tonight. We scouted them all weekend. I think the defense played really well. You have to give all the credit to the DBs back there. They held them all so we can get the sacks up front.
How much better you think this front 7 is than last year?
We're a lot better because we realized some of the mistakes we made last year, and we want to become number one. I mean, we want to be number one in the league, and we want to go out and prove it.
How much did you have the chance to watch your quarterback there when you were sitting on the bench?
I got a lot of chance. I mean, we're behind him 110%. We think he can go out there and get it done for us, and he's going to keep getting better each and every week.
Sean, thanks.
All right, thank you.
All right. This was the 3rd shutout in week one. The last time that there were 3 or more shutouts in week one of an NFL season, 1977.
I was a young man then.
You're still a young man, Coach. You're still a young man. He's like 32 years young or something like that. It was all San Diego in Oakland's hometown. Philip Rivers gets his first NFL touchdown pass of the season. LaDainian Tomlinson turned to me and said afterwards, now we're having fun.
Thanks, man. More NFL inside this 90-minute Sports Center, including why Game 1 of Monday Night Football's first ever doubleheader turned into a fourth-quarter thriller. Plus, why the Patriots might have lost one of the biggest impact players they have and how long the Chiefs will now be without Trent Green. And from 2 critical September series in Anaheim and Minnesota, why the White Sox are loving a red-hot Frank Thomas right about now. We'll be right back.
Introducing the new 2007 Yukon Denali. The definition of great engineering.
This is Gary Poole, a genial guy from Trenton, New Jersey. Gary's been married for almost 10 years, but until a recent trip to McDonald's, didn't know it. Gary had fresh brewed premium roast coffee with his McGriddles, and it was like he was seeing her for the very first time.
He had no idea we were married.
Gary thought she was cute, so it was okay.
It's like we're newlyweds all over again.
Start your morning with richer, bolder premium roast coffee and add a warm, tasty McGriddles. Wake up and smell your life.
I hope there aren't any other wives.
SportsCenter, brought to you by GMC. Engineered to the highest standard. Professional grade.
A poignant day and evening, to say the least, in the nation's capital. 184 lights shining on the Pentagon, remembering those who perished. 9/11/01, 5 years ago. Hi, everybody. Chris Berman, Steve Young, Michael Irvin, Tom Jackson. They also had football in the nation's capital. They do love their Redskins. But the theme from over the weekend, road teams coming in to play these big home teams and home openers, and the road teams doing really well. Could Minnesota on, as we said, a more than poignant day with American flags, the stars and stripes of 90,000 plus in FedEx Field. Clinton Portis back for the Redskins, but so was Brad Johnson. Led the Redskins once upon a time to a division championship, and on the very first series, hits this bomb to Troy Williamson. Minnesota wasn't afraid to air it out, Steve.
Not at all. In fact, I thought he threw the long ball very nicely. A very solid game for Brad Johnson. We always talked about how consistent he is. There it was again.
On third and goal from the four, an interesting call up the middle, Tom, for a touchdown.
Look at the beautiful block by Steve Hutchinson. Block out, block back in, Chester Taylor into the end zone. Boom.
They do botch the extra point at 6-0. Now, the first string offense for the Redskins didn't score in the preseason. They hit a lot of the new playbook of Al Saunders, and plays like this were hitting. Mark Brunell swinging to Santana Moss. At least the book was open, guys.
Yeah, we talked about that in the demo, Santana Moss on the bubble screen.
Clinton Portis up the middle for a yard on second and eight, so not all the new plays were run. Vikings' tough interior line holds them to field goal 6-3. Johnson to Williamson, and you can't make the throw any better than that. You can make a little better catch, guys.
Oh, it was a great throw. And this play, Troy Williamson, he has to make this play. He's going to be the big-time receiver, the number one receiver for the Minnesota Vikings. He has to make that play.
Antoine Randle-L, you want excitement? Watch this on the punt return and whoop! And then some of his guys get in the action here. Let's watch Sean Taylor. Bang! And then Carlos Rogers, what's going to happen here, guys? It's bang! There's some special teams. And the most exciting play of the night as Randle-L makes a big return with the blocks. So we drive third and four from the 35. Brunell swings it to, there's Randle. Look at this again. And he still moves now. Brunell, kind of the counter swing to Liddell Dickey Betts, who strums his guitar inside the 10, which sets up the Redskins. And now here's Clinton Portis, didn't start, but he finished this drive.
Yeah, Clinton Portis, great blocking on the outside. Great job of following his block, even having his hand on the blocker, letting him lead in into the front corner of the end zone. Boom.
So then the Minnesota Vikings trailing 13-9 at the half. Right away in the third quarter, cuckoo cuckoo, Marcus Robinson catches the bomb from Brad Johnson. Fourth quarter, we're tied at 16. First down to Williamson. Sean Taylor called for face mask. And so Minnesota had couple of long drives in the second half, and then it sets up just over a minute to go. Ryan Longwell, 31 yards, good. Vikings lead 19-16. A minute left for the Redskins. Can Mark Brunell get something going? They look for Santana Moss, guys. Makes a catch at the 38, the Vikes. And then third and six, Brunell to Randle-L, stops the clock, but doesn't get the first. And so you felt that tying field goal coming, but this is no chip shot. John Hall, 48 yards, and no shot.
Boomer, you got to hit the net. You might miss the field goal, but you're a pro. Yeah. You got to hit the net.
So field goal, no good. The Vikings come on the road and beat the Redskins by the count of 19-16. Steve, you called it on Monday Night Countdown, the type of game that Brad Johnson would have, 16-30 for 223. The Portis ran some, but the running star in this game was Chester Taylor, Tom. So as we look at the new Minnesota Vikings of Brad Childress, so congratulations to Brad. who goes in and in his first game ever as head coach beats a Hall of Fame coach in his stadium, in Joe Gibbs. The new look Vikings run the ball.
Not only that, but I loved how Brad Childress put a stamp on it. He deactivated the safety before the game. Mm-hmm. He let Dante Culpepper go. This is my team. I'm going to be a balanced, efficient, no-mistake football team, and they played like it first game out.
You know, the team is built to run the football. We talk about McKinney and Hutchinson, and you've got Matt Burke at that center spot. Chester Taylor had 31 rushes. This is the first time that a Vikings running back has had 30-plus carries. The last time it happened, Robert Smith, 1996, 10 years ago. So it's not the 88 yards that Chester Taylor got. It's the way they control the football with that offensive line and the running game.
And so Taylor, it also showed, you know, he's got low mileage. Okay, came from Baltimore, didn't run the ball. It's the original tires on the car, even though he's been in the league for a few years, he's got some zip. And Brad Johnson, Stephen Michael, I mean, he knows what he's doing.
Yeah, Brad did. I must say he surprised me some, because watching him live right in the stadium, you see his arm and you think, man, this guy's getting older. Maybe he doesn't have the arm strength, but he threw that deep ball nice. He threw it real nice. He had good air up under it. Look at this, a quick pump. He got the ball back up in the air for the touchdown. He made some great throws, and he could do some great things with the type of discipline and structure they have in Minnesota now.
And even in a losing effort, you have to be encouraged, because the Redskins look so much better than they looked in the preseason.
They did, but they lost their zip in offense. They had it in the second
quarter.
They have
the most talent in the league. They're underachieving to their talent right now. The speed they had, it was unbelievable what they had out there. They did not show well today, I don't think.
You know, they played Dallas, and one of those two teams will be 0-2.
We'll see them.
There it is from FedEx Field, where we positively, absolutely delivered a Vikings 19-16 win. Scotty.
Boom, thanks very much. And you compare the quarterbacks, and the key on third down, and Johnson was good. The toughest thing in the league is when you can't get the other team off the field, and Johnson was not spectacular, but he was efficient. Kept moving the chains, moving the chains, moving the chains. 10 of 15, averaged nearly 12 yards per pass attempt. And after the game, after Johnson outdueled Brunell and the Vikings outdueled the Redskins, Brad Childress was given a game ball.
I feel tremendously humbled, you know, a little bit emotional after the game, but I'm just happy for those guys, most of all in the locker room. They put in a lot of hard work, and there's a pretty good buy-in factor when you come up with a win.
It was electrifying out there. I mean, it was something special in warm-ups and the whole game. It was loud. Playing here is a hostile environment, and they have a great team, and fortunate for us, we came out with a win there in the end.
Kind of back and forth. We probably had a chance to win it a number of places, and they eventually made the play to win the game for us, so I felt like we gave ourselves a chance. Our guys kept fighting, but it was they made the last play, the one that counted.
Clinton Portis spent his week downplaying his chances of being ready to start, said you'll see 2-6 for Dallas. Well, he played in this one after dislocating his shoulder on August 13th in a preseason game. Afterwards, he explained the emotions and the feelings after being back on the field.
No, I didn't know if they was going to let me play tonight or not, but having the opportunity to go on the field, once the adrenaline started going and the crowd getting into the game, you know, the little pain or whatever, you know, go away after that first play. I felt good, you know. I think just running to the linebacker on the first gut I got to test it out to see how I was going to hold up, it gave me a great opportunity that I was feeling okay. And I think coaching them saw that and called my number a little more than I thought they would.
Just a fashion observation. Sean Merriman, Portis, and I believe Chad Johnson all rocking the Frohawks early on in the season. We'll keep an eye on that. Keep an eye on the Redskins on the ground. 103 yards as a team, but 38 of those came on two carries, 23 on an attempt by Santana Moss. Portis averaged 22 carries, 95 yards a game. The last season held considerably under that. Liddell Betts under 3 yards per carry. T.J. Duckett, the new running back, did not play.
All right, is this it? Have the Patriots finally let go of a player they simply cannot replace? Straight ahead, why Deion Branch will be the man Bill Belichick ends up missing the most. Forget the wild card. The Twins just might win the Central outright. White Sox, though, right there as well. Up next, the Twins hosting the A's. White Sox, way out west. We'll be right back.
dishing out his double whopper. Triples too, all season long.
Why you always get the front seat?
Because I have a higher education.
What do you
I
mean?
I took honors classes.
In high school.
Hey, it's Bobby Bowden.
I'm going to touch him.
Now would be a good time to have accident forgiveness.
I'm still going to touch him.
Part of Allstate Your Choice Auto Insurance. Are you in good hands?
That wasn't him.
But you still touched him.
Ergonomic desk chairs? I watched their back. $650. Office pet?
/ watchdog.
$100. Laptops instead of desktops?
Big ideas don't only come between 9 and 5.
$999 each. Running your business your way. No questions asked.
Nice.
Priceless. Use your MasterCard business card for a chance to win $50,000 for your business.
Saturday Night Football on ABC. Nebraska versus USC this Saturday at 8.
Jeez, that's a big truck.
Yeah.
It has the world's biggest cab.
Where's the truck?
The all-new Dodge Ram Mega Cab. Yeah, it's that big. Right now, well-qualified buyers can get 0% financing for 72 months on 2006 Ram 1500 Quad Cab.
Not easy to deal with an idiot, and this man over the course of the years has tried my patience and if he was any kind of a man would quit talking about things in the paper and return a phone call or come knock on somebody's door. If I had the kind of problems evidently he has with me, I'd go knock on his door.
White Sox general manager Kenny Williams red hot at Frank Thomas in that February interview, felt Chicago's greatest bat ever was hitting below the belt and criticizing the organization after his release. Thomas is the hot one now. His a different kind of heat, the kind Chicago knows can melt Minnesota's game and a half wild card lead. Oakland's big hurt with big numbers in his last 12 games. 8 homers, 21 RBI. Part of Thomas's beef with Chicago? A diminished skills clause in his contract. Minnesota, where the Twins are just 2 games behind the division-leading Tigers. Thomas' skills include homers in 5 straight games. Bartender! 6-pack! Thomas off Carlos Silva is 36. He sets an A's record by homering in 6 straight games, 2 shy of the Major League record. Bottom 4, Michael Kadire, 2-run homer off Joe Blanton, his 22nd, and the Twins take a 2-1 lead. Now 3-1 in the bottom of the 6th, Torrey Hunter. His 24th comes off Blanton, who said afterwards he felt like he was struggling with his command all night. Oh, you think so, doctor? It was 6-1, it's now 6-3. We're in the 8th inning. Joe Nathan relieves Jesse Crane. Bases loaded, 2 out. Marco Scudero with a chance to take the lead. First pitch swinging, pops out to 3rd. Nathan and the Twins get out of the jam. Nathan will get 4 outs, pick up save number 31, and the Twins go on to win it 9-4. Frank Thomas slugging his way through September. 10 games, 8 homers, 19 RBI, .395 batting average. He's a lifetime .307 hitter. Thomas, 36 home runs this season, leave him just 16 shy of the .500 club.
ALCS rematch. Both teams on the outside looking in of the playoffs at the moment. John Lackey, he's come up big in some big spots. Strikes out Scott Pesednik Tadahito Iguchi looking as well. Lackey struck out 8 in 8 innings. Jose Contreras matched him K for K. Bottom second. Contreras. Filthy to Howie Kendrick. Adam Kennedy as well. That is an unbelievable breaking ball. 8 Ks, 8 innings. Top four, Lackey gets some defensive help. Jermaine Dye lines one off the glove of Lackey. Adam Kennedy, a spectacular play, and then doubles off Iguchi at first. Iguchi is stunned. The top five, no score, 2-1 for A.J. Pierzynski. All this guy does is deliver and deliver and deliver. He scores Jim Thome. The White Sox lead Bob Marley. One love. Until Paul Konerko delivers Joe Creedy. And the Sox lead 2-0. The move to the ninth inning, Bobby Jenks on the close. He's been sketchy of late, blown his last two saves. It's a 3-1 game, runners on the corners, nobody out, and then Juan Rivera, 4-6-3, double play. Vlad Guerrero does score from third, so it's a 3-2 game. And then Kendrick on the 0-2 pitch. That's it, that's all. The White Sox win it 3-2, save number 40 for the big fella. Take inventory of the playoff situation in the Central. The Twins, only a game and a half out of the lead. They were 8 games under 500 and 11 and a half games out the morning of June the 8th. That has all changed. And good news for the Twins, who own that game and a half lead in the wild card. Francisco Liriano has been activated, likely to pitch on Wednesday.
Did the Seahawks pick up a pass-catching version of Larry Brown, or did New England just trade the next Lynn Swann? Only history will tell, but Deion Branch's Patriot days are history. Former Super Bowl MVP shipped to Seattle for a 2007 first-round pick. Last time Seattle gave up a one to get someone, 5 years ago when they landed quarterback Matt Hasselbeck. Branch was holding out for a new deal. Seattle will oblige. Branch had coming off a career year last season, 78 catches, 998 yards, 5 touchdowns. Hawks coach Mike Holmgren unsure when Branch will be ready to go. Richard Seymour, sorry to see his former teammate gone.
I'm happy for him to get a new contract and be back out on the football field, playing football. So in that regard, I'm very happy for him. But I guess, in my own, selfish reasons, I want him in a Patriot uniform. And, obviously I don't control that. And he doesn't to some degree as well. So, I don't know, it's just disappointing to say the least. I think, you look back a few years ago at the Lawyer Malloy situation, this is times, 83.
Well, it's actually times 4 if you look back to who they had last season. Remember us? Willie McGinnis now with the Browns, sack king. David Gibbons now with the Titans, good hands man. Adam Vinatieri, 3 Super Bowl rings, Superfoot, and now Deion Branch. Where have you gone?
For some more perspective now on this trade, we welcome in Sean Salisbury. And Sean, the New England organization has taken a bunch of hits. And now you look at the wide receivers that have moved on. David Givens, a career high in receptions last year. He's in Tennessee. Now Branch, a career high in receptions last year, moves on to Seattle. At what point do they finally have an impact on the offense, and particularly Brady?
Scott, you make a great point. Doesn't there have to be a point of diminishing returns?
I guess so.
There's no question about it. And you look at the impact it has on the New England Patriots. Is you can only go to the tight end and throw the ball to Kevin Falk so many times. You've got an MVP-type player in Tom Brady. But last week against Buffalo, this past weekend, you can eventually squeeze. And if you're any kind of defense at all, I can take your best player away. That being said, we saw them run the ball a little bit better, which they're going to need to. But with Graham and Ben Watson, you can't continue to just rely on the tight end because things like this happen. You must have a game breaker wide receiver. And so, Scott, it gets to the point, as good as the Patriots organization has been, when do you got to get Brady some more help to where he doesn't have to carry a full franchise on his back, which he's doing offensively right now?
You saw the Maroney and Dillon two-headed monster.
I need it.
Might be a heavy dose of that running the ball from
40 times,
from
maybe.
Belichick. On the other side of this now, Seattle, a team that went to the Super Bowl last year, gets a former Super Bowl MVP to go along with Bobby Engram and Darryl Jackson. How does he impact that team?
Explosion, Scott. How many times have you seen a quarterback like Hasselbeck did this last week and go 25 out of 30, and yet you get no touchdowns out of it? We know we got one of the better quarterbacks in the NFC, but remember, this is a former Super Bowl MVP who can run after the catch. He gives you the explosive speed, and even when he doesn't catch the ball, you got him on the perimeter outside to open it up in the inner lanes and to get Sean Alexander going. Remember, they lose Steve Hutchinson, so their run game is going to suffer a little bit at the offensive guard. But with Branch, it gives you the ability to stretch a field. And then when you dump it, those six-yard dumps become 15-yard gains. And one other thing about this where the Patriots lose, we know Seattle's what? The easiest road to the Final Four?
Right.
I mean, to home field advantage?
Right.
Let's say they get to the Final Four, Scott, or close to the Super Bowl. You're talking about your first-round pick is going to be a 29, 30, 31, or 32. So it's not like the Patriots are getting a top-five pick. You can never be guaranteed that a late first-round pick is going to pan out.
All right. Sean Salisbury, you're free to go for now, but we'll be seeing you a little bit later in this
little
program.
GMC love later?
If you'll do it.
I'll be here.
Outstanding.
All right.
LaDainian Tomlinson and the Chargers shut out the Raiders 27-0 on Monday night. Third shutout of week one. Last time there were three or more shutouts in week one back in 1977 when there were five shutouts. From shutouts to shoutouts from Brad Nessler, Dick Vermeil, and Ron Jaworski.
This is certainly not how Art Schell had it planned for his second tour of duty as a head coach of the Oakland Raiders, as tonight 27-0 is the final. And Dick, I know you've coached against Marty Schottenheimer, Art Schell. It's got to be a terrible feeling to get zapped at home like they did. But Marty Schottenheimer and Wade Phillips' defense, sensational for the Chargers.
Dominating. They dominated the line of scrimmage against the run. So they couldn't run. So now they've got up to their third and long situations. Here they're trying to run the ball outside. No yards. Now they go to passing game. They're in third and long too many times. He's getting his butt knocked off. He's losing more yards, getting sacked, than he's making throwing the ball downfield. I've never seen an offense this inept.
Nine sacks tonight for the San Diego Chargers. Seven of those suffered by Aaron Brooks, who was the starting quarterback. He ended the game with six completions, got sacked seven times. On the other side, we started the night talking about Phillip Rivers. First start for him in a San Diego Charger uniform. And Jaws, they didn't ask him to do much because he didn't have to do that much because he had number 21 behind him.
Phillip Rivers only threw the ball 11 times. Marty Schottenheimer managed his game. That meant LaDainian Tomlinson had to wear the hat. And boy, did he wear the big sombrero. He ran inside. He ran outside. He broke tackles. He went over the top. He was the true Superman, leaping into the air with a single bound for a touchdown. And he has just been terrific in Oakland. Look at these last five games here. Look at the number of rushes. 39, 28, 37, 31, and tonight, 31 for a buck 31. Also caught three passes in the ballgame, 34 touches. Warren Sapp told us at our meeting on Saturday, he thought LaDainian Tomlinson would touch the ball 40 times. Warren was pretty close.
He really was. A near-perfect performance. No turnovers suffered by San Diego tonight. They didn't allow a sack, and they only had three penalties. And tonight, a resounding win, 27-0. Lamont Jordan tells the story right there. Six straight victories for the Chargers over the Oakland Raiders.
Thank you, man. Still ahead, several critical injuries from the NFL's first week, including perhaps a season changer in the NFC. And on the subject of injuries, the Kansas City Chiefs announced just how long they'll be without the services of Trent Green. Plus, just one base away from baseball immortality, could Alfonso Soriano swipe the show in Arizona?
Nothing like shopping for a little fresh produce. Can never get enough fiber. Yeah, this is all way more interesting than us debating who's going to win this year's Heisman. Let me think. Quinn and Peterson or legumes and zucchini? At least